fraud niggas, y'all niggas, that's that shit I don't like. Yo shit, make believe, rapping about my own life. Woo! That's Rand nigga, woo! Ric Flair nigga, woo! The power's in my head nigga. Style!
Now she went though. You already know though. Only live once, step in my life.
Hold something up when I take it out the stash. When I buy a house, I'ma pay straight cash. So I'ma flip a stack that don't make it come back.
Take the girl, get napper. Beat it to my mattress. A skeleton in my closet. It's probably when he dead and rapper.
She can have a Grammy, I still treat her like a nominee. Just need to know what that book like, so one time is fine with me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yep. So we here.
Take two.
Yeah, take two.
Difficulties.
Y'all probably not going to see take one. So, again, that weather out there is crazy. Man, we was going to war. I thought Elle flew here and threw Gramps on her back. That's why Gramps is sitting here. It's crazy. Yeah.
Low-key recap.
Low recap. Y'all missed that. You know what I'm saying? It was probably a better delivery when it first happened. But we here, though. You know what I'm saying? SD World Vision. Just Rock the Mic Radio. We here. Elle is here on the thread, but you here, hanging in there.
We're all actually here.
Yeah, it's been a rough week, man. This is the first time the team been here in a long time. The whole entire team, we here. Latasha's here. You know, we got some people to put on blast to the season, to be blasting. Wonderful thing, yeah.
Wow, yeah. I like the first
Yeah, it's great, man. It's a wonderful thing, man. Got something fun for us to do. I mentioned that as well.
Gramps is thirsty, so.
As always, in every shape or form, you know.
So wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
So wrong.
So what's up? What y'all doing for the holidays?
Oh, man. You know, I'm be with the fam, man. You know, I'm going to Jersey, man. Mm. Show the fam over there.
Fam time.
Know. Yeah, yeah, it's the time to be with the fam holiday time.
I'll be drinking.
Yeah, we know. I mean, you got what? Of course, somewhere.
Drink.
Yo, I was watching. Speaking of that, I was watching something with Michael Blackson. You know Michael Blackson, yo.
Oh, my God. Yo. No, I wish I didn't.
Yo,
okay.
He was talking about, like, you know, bitch niggas, like, right? So he, you know, of course, he kind of gave one to Kendrick Lamar. He gave him an award for that. You know, and he was like, yo, like, you know, talking about the pour up drink. He was like, she need a pool full of liquor to, you know, if she going, any chick want to date him, she going to need a pool full of liquor because of all them naps. And it's,
oh, snap.
He do got a lot of naps in his head, though. I mean, it's crazy. But I'm just saying, you know, it's swag, you know what I'm saying?
That joke didn't make any sense.
Well, maybe you find Kendrick Lamar attractive, so maybe
no,
that's
no,
probably...
I'm still trying to actually get the joke. Michael Blackson.
Well, you know, it's Michael Blackson. I'm not gonna do it with the accent and all that. You know what I'm saying?
Oh no, I know his accent. I'm still not amused.
It's probably just funny because he has the African accent.
Yeah, I saw him on what was it? A court show one day.
Oh man, I think I heard. I didn't see it personally, but
that
I heard
hilarious.
About that. Yeah.
I think he left the show and now he was being sued because he left the college show for their homecoming.
Yeah,
it was Michael
Blackson. Right. Yeah.
And half of everybody was like, "Who's Michael Blackson?" And then the other half was like, "Oh yeah, that world star nigga." So
I'm done, yo. Oh man. Well, a couple things, man. We'll talk about today, man. I know. Since I got you and Latasha here, this is gonna be great, man. But I want to talk about, like, you know, when does he cheat? You know what I mean? Like, when is it? You know, like, it's if you cook, you know, like, when is it, when is too little to spend on a date? Like, it's $50 a cheap date.
I'll let you know personally how I feel, because I'll let you know.
Yeah.
And you might be surprised.
Yeah, I mean, like,
might,
you know,
not be a response that you think that I
and then also, the, you know, of course, the addition to that is, you know, is it all about the money? You know what I mean? Like, does he have to have,
thanks
you know,
for bringing that up. You know, that was one of my reasons.
Like, you know, if he was broke, would you, you know, and he was just a really genuine guy, would you give him a chance? Or, you know, is it, you know, does he have to, or is there a certain standard
you
of money or whatever?
Shut up and give me my mind back, please. Chemo.
Yeah, well, you know,
oh my God.
You know, well, you know, I do have a sixth sense, you know. I was raised by all women, so, you know, I mean, you know, I might know how to tap into that mind. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yo, what's up, Gramps? What's going on, man? What's up, Leo?
Ain't nothing. I'm chilling. What's up with you?
I'm good, man. Just glad to have a team here, man.
I'm glad to be here.
This is wonderful.
You know?
Man,
I'm in a little pain.
This is amazing, man.
I woke up like, damn, it's Saturday?
Yeah.
I'm a little sick,
gotta, everyone. Gotta go to the show?
I had to get up and
let me smoke an L.
It's crazy because I ain't speak to you all week.
Yeah, Gramps.
Word, man.
Answer them emails,
word,
too, goddamn
it. You haven't
seen that's the problem. I don't check my emails like that. I got to call me on my phone.
I just
want
to let you know.
Oh,
like,
boy.
They just text me like, yo, Gramps, check your email. That's yo. And then I just check my email.
And tech or text.
Man,
forget email. It's really, about it's, a hi. How are you?
It's crazy. Like, it's really like talking to my grandmama and my grandpops, man. When I talking to them, you know, it's like.
But you think about it though. Like,
your new name now is Grams. It's gonna be Grams and Gramps.
Yours will be Leave It to Beaver.
Oh well.
Well, you do got the job done.
So that's all good. So hey, I be Leave It to Beaver. At least I get the job done. Boom. Yeah, yeah. No. We
take it away, Johnny.
Let's go. Let's do it. Let's take it away. Take it away. Yo, man. So Elle, tell me. What is it you think? Like, let me ask you this question. If, you know, you got a guy and y'all maybe, you know, you talking for a little bit, you know, and you say, hey, you know, I want you to come over, you know, I'm gonna cook you some dinner, you know, I'm gonna cook dinner for you. He cooks dinner for you, you know. The second time you come over, he cooks dinner. He's always cooking you dinner, right? But he never takes you out to eat. Would you look at that like, oh, he's just being cheap, he don't want to take me out to dinner? Or you will look at it like, well, you know, would you just appreciate the fact that he, you know, is taking time to cook for you?
Now, it could be one of two things. Either he's staying at his mom's house and he's using the free crib all the time and he's using that to his advantage. Or he probably doesn't want to take me out and has a lot of food.
What if
he
just want to cook?
Like, yeah, maybe
right,
he's
what
just.
What if
you
want to
there's
cook?
There's a lot of cholesterol in some things that you could. Like, maybe you. What? No, hold on now. You know, you're not. Could we just not go out? Can I see the outside of your wall? Walls?
Hold on.
Once
hold on.
I don't do that. Pineapples.
You don't find a guy that really cooks out there, you know? So that's kind of rare.
Yo, wait
okay,
wait,
yes, but
yo,
can
wait,
you let
wait
me
a minute,
finish?
Wait a minute.
I know that was all wonderful and all, but...
I got something to say.
Uh-oh. Kanye.
Oh, shit.
Please.
Oh, shit.
Like, I'm not Taylor Smith. I will not.
Swift.
I don't listen to country.
He said that was nice and all that, but I got something to say though. You was cool with your little,
I know,
I didn't
say number two. Here comes the guys.
Yo, respect it though, because Sean never interferes. He never gets involved. So you know, if Sean gets involved, he may say, "Choke it, red pill, blue pill." Next showcase coming up. Give me a beer. Put them on blast.
Mind you, I had like
a couple
of strawberry vodkas before I got here.
Nice. But now, what's up?
That's not an excuse. Don't have a lot of alcohol.
Oh, shit. Now, what's good? What you got to say?
Oh, you had any cheap dates? If you did, blast them, please.
Put them on.
Let's go.
I told you. They come. That's all he wanted to say.
But what's a cheap date, though? Like,
yeah. If you got a cheap date, put their ass on
blast. Put on blast.
What's a cheap date? Go ahead.
Is McDonald's a cheap date?
You know what? He's such a listen. Oh no, it's not. Never has anyone taken me to McDonald's. Yeah. I probably was already at McDonald's.
I've never been
there
before.
That's
an accent.
I can double size.
Wait,
super
wait,
size
wait,
my own meal.
I have to intervene.
Oh no, please come on, seriously.
Here comes Beast.
Can I say my number two first of all before you come in?
No,
y'all just know
when you make a statement.
I think
it has to be acknowledged. You know what I'm saying? We have to debate this.
Let's go.
First of all,
yeah.
I respect a chick.
Uh-huh. I didn't even get to say what my moment was. Why are you all coming at my one? I'm really not going to listen.
Hold on. I'm going to say this.
Let me say why I'm not going to listen. haven't said even number two yet.
Okay, go say your number two. Go ahead.
Say your number two.
Say your number two.
Listen, don't play it to push a bra either. Just say
it. Well, actually, my underarms could be kind of itch. I'm seeing titties. She want to put me on blast. Up and down. And yes, and I see you looking, and it's kind of creepy. But I just wanted to say.
No, but if your hand is moving,
if I'm going like this, then what does that mean?
And if you're scratching.
I look more like an orangutan. That's what I look like. Yes, I do. A little bit. Just a little bit.
All right.
Underarms itch sometimes, ladies and gentlemen. We just have to scratch it.
We got it.
You mean your titties look like a orangutan? What do you mean?
I said I look in the presence of an orangutan. I'm sorry that you might not will know that.
Number two,
honey.
I'm kind of twisted right now.
Number two.
I don't know.
I'll just let you guys talk. I guess this conversation was enough
number two
to me.
All right, check this out. This is what we're going to do. You intervene. Get out, since we're talking about that, and then we're going to get to your number two. Fair enough?
I didn't even get to the story. Didn't you even mention a story somewhere around this line?
Well, we're going to listen. Don't worry.
No,
we on one subject.
I was waiting for the number two. I said, let me be a gentleman and let Elle get her number two.
I was saying a half hour ago.
Elle, you're not going to get my props? You're not going to
drama?
Number two.
You're not going to get my props?
You sit there, and you know, okay, dinner's good once, twice, three times. Four times, five times. Oh, are we going out? Am I going to breathe some outside, air today? Are we going to at least go to Central Park? You know, it doesn't even have to be like necessarily going out to eat. Can it be like outside of springtime? Maybe we can go to the park. You can fry your chicken and take it outside, and we can go to the park.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, you know, black love. Right, but right. I'm just saying, it doesn't necessarily have to be. Oh, I'm in your house, so you know. Maybe I can. The way to a woman's heart is through her. But you
stomach,
know,
that's really profound. Though, what's going on? I mean,
I don't think she was gonna say her stomach, bro.
Okay. Yeah. Well, if it's anywhere else, I mean, I think most men would love that anyway. I mean, what you really talking about?
Stuffing
I mean,
and chicken. I'm just.
I mean, you know, Thanksgiving would be my favorite holiday.
Yeah.
No, okay.
Yo.
Gobble. Okay.
Stuff that turkey. Yeah. Stuff that turkey. Okay. Anyway, go ahead.
Okay, you've been watching too much South Park and Martha Stewart.
What? No, I don't even watch. I haven't watched South Park since I was.
Just look at like I've low key seen that episode with Martha Stewart and the stuffed turkey. I have.
Yes.
Be seen it.
I'm mad you brought.
I seen
that
it
up.
Online as well.
I'm not messing with you.
Word. It's crazy. So.
Yo, you ain't even finished this drink. You all right, though?
Like, yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
All right.
I'm mad. Gramps got the pimp cup. You know what I'm saying?
I'm saying, real G's do real things.
You know what I'm saying?
Got my little special, portable pimp cup.
We'll see if you can show up. Together.
You guys, you hear the plastic?
It don't matter, though. I'm still pimping, baby.
He's still pimping.
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't even have your name on the cup.
I don't need a name on the cup.
He got a plastic chalice. That's pimping.
Hey.
Balling on that budget. Balling on that budget. Okay. Yeah. Anyway. So, Gramps, I got to get your side, man. I mean, like, what do you feel like? You know what I mean? Like, you know, if you cooking for a female, man, and you know, and she call you a cheap date. I mean, do you think it's a cheap date if you just genuinely want to cook for your female or... You know, how you feel about that?
I feel like if I'm cooking for you, you better appreciate that shit. Because not a lot of times I'm not going to cook. Now, be honest with you. Like, I'm not saying that, like, a female can't be treated nice, you know? Like, a lot of females do need to be treated nice. A lot of guys don't appreciate their females. But, you know, but I'm saying, though, if you got the nerve to be like, oh, you cheap, you don't take me out, no, bitch, you could go outside and go get your food yourself. Like, I'm cooking right now for you. Like, we're going to eat. We can go outside later if you want to go outside, but you're going to eat. Like,
wow.
Like I said, we can't even cook it and make your chicken and go outside with the chicken, maybe to a park.
You go outside if it's 25 degrees.
No, we're not talking about December, nigga. Ain't nobody, everybody black.
Damn.
Damn, yo.
Like I said, listen.
We are black.
She better appreciate that shit, cause it's not.
I don't think you can do that. We barely.
What guy? How many guys you ever seen really that cook like that though? Like honestly, how many guys do you know that cook?
I can count on a hand.
That cooks for you. That two. Actually two guys.
Yeah. Which is very rare. I said about to sound like that's Elmer Fudd, where, but
A where? Oh man, I'm done with y'all, man. Well,
what's up with you, though? What you feel about that, though?
I mean, me personally, like, I cook, so, you know what I mean? I look at it like, you know, you got to have a balance,
well, though. Me, myself, I microwave. So.
That's cool. You know what? You know what?
Microwave and oven.
It's the thought.
Ramen noodles and Goya assassin for him.
It's the thought that counts, right? Like, it's really the thought that counts, right? So if you say, listen, you know, I want to do something, it's a generous thing. And I mean, this hopefully
tastes
good.
And I would appreciate it.
And I mean, and if she's, and if she really into you,
it'll
and all that,
like,
she's going to appreciate
it. 20,000 times, man.
Right, but, you know, yeah, you, she, she's going to appreciate taking her out. Now, here's the deal. You know what I mean? Like, if you want to take her out, if you're not going to, if you just cook her for all the time, you may not take her out to dinner because you may have your personal feelings about that, but take her out somewhere. So then at the end of the day, she can't be like, we'll never go out anywhere, and you just keep me in your crib.
She starts saying, why is the cage bird saying?
That's not sense, because, you know, women, they like to be, you know, they like to be shown off. You know what I mean? They like to be, they want to feel, because, you know, a lot of women, even the most beautiful women are some insecure sometimes. So, you know, they start to think like, well, damn, am I not pretty enough? Does he not feel proud of me?
Or maybe
I'm
nervous.
Some women, you know, they think, and they're just like, maybe they have someone out on the show. They see it. Maybe they don't want to, you know.
Yeah, yeah, right, right. Even that.
Maybe
right.
It's another woman. Maybe I'm just the caged bird.
Or maybe he just don't want another man stealing what he has. Think. He probably afraid.
At times. Like, damn.
But you got some guy that's afraid that they don't want to take their girl outside because they don't want another man to take what they have, you know.
That is true.
I've seen that happen before. That was funny. Like, I mean, it wasn't funny, but it was funny.
Yeah,
like,
that. But you also right. You got to keep that in mind, though. You're right. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Sure. So. I feel like, yeah, this me. And what? Yo, oh, yeah, bro. Thank you. Like, you know, just do that. So.
Yeah.
And build your confidence. Oh, yeah, but my cheapest date.
Yeah, what's your cheapest date?
I got in a car. It was like, this is probably like.
What's his name?
Sophomore. No, I can't even put him on blast because he was such a non-factor. I don't remember. I only saw him once. This was the only date, pretty much. So he's unknown man somewhere in the world or in America.
Mm-hmm.
And picked me up from my house. Yeah, he had a nice little car.
Right.
So we were just driving around, driving. After a while, it was like 30 minutes. I look down at my phone. We're talking, having a good conversation. I look back up. I'm right back in front of my house.
Wait, hold on. So you tell me.
We parked, and I'm like, aren't we? Where are we going anywhere? You know, I took a shower and got dressed.
Yo, you had a whole conversation looking down at your phone.
It wasn't really no. I looked down at my phone. I just didn't. I didn't do the long version of the whole story. It was just bam, boom, A, B, C, not A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
I'm about the same thing.
Yeah, I looked down at my phone for a second because you know you like to glance at your phone to look at the time, the internet, whatever. Look back up, look outside the window. This is my house, like, you know? We're having like a good conversation, just glancing, so looking down, like, okay, yeah, we're going.
He just took you for a drill ride, basically.
Wow.
He didn't even feed you.
Well, at least you got a little vibe, you know.
He didn't even feed you.
I eat anyways before I leave the house. See, that's just me. I am a fatty anyways. Pause. But pause. Damn.
You've seen it coming.
Seriously.
I didn't say nothing. I just, you know.
Well,
we keep looking like,
Check this out, right? You know, it's holiday time, man. We gotta make sure we gotta meet. You know, this is our, you know, our first show before last show before Christmas, man. So we gotta get in the spirit, man. So I thought it'd be perfect, right, to play some Christmas music, man. I think it's perfect.
You laughing at Sean?
No, you're not playing no.
I think we got some
good deal music.
You made DMX? Don't give it away.
You just gave it all away.
Well, here, I mean, yes, DMX, this, for the audience watching.
Like, oh, DMX in it. Like, how much?
Well, I mean, you didn't give it away, but people that's tuned in, people, check this out, man. DMX, yo, yes, DMX. Remember that was it, that dude. He apparently has made a Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer song, man, for the holidays, man. I think it's great. It gets us in the Christmas spirit, right? It just makes
your sarcasm is very uncanny.
Well, you know,
like if, you can't possibly be serious.
I'm not being serious. I like DMX. Don't
DMX?
DMX. I just want to.
Sounds like he just took a sniff or a shot of some inanimate object.
I'm just gonna play it. I mean, we're just gonna start playing some right now. I want to see what y'all think. You know, I think it's a wonderful song. I think it's great. I mean, the fact that he's, you know, hey, DMX.
Where my dog's at?
Where my dog's at?
What? What?
Let it play.
Yo, he needs some strippers in that video.
Like I said the first time, he sounds like he just shot up or snorted an inanimate object, got into the booth.
DMX, that's how you do it. That's how you get that Christmas money, prayer.
And some you have to bring those
That gentleman was crack. I like it.
You had like crack as like the crack he probably took before he did that song.
I ain't saying all that. I said it was crack. I ain't say all that.
That's the knack.
As Jamie Foxx would say, I ain't saying he a crack head. It's just crack ish. He's just crack ish. Just saying, you know?
Instead of couples therapy, we shall talk about Dr. Drew's celebrity rehab.
And then he feeds Rudolph to his dogs. End of story. Yeah. DMX, man. What you thought about
still
that?
Breeding?
Oh,
those dogs?
No, I mean, well, it's rain. Rudolph the red nose. I think
you're beating reindeers now.
Who's that? Where my deer's at? You know what I'm saying?
You need to do a remix to that joint, yo. Or get the locks on there. I think
Jadakiss would.
He's just being fed by the breakfast club. Shout out to 957.
Shout out to DMX for trying. 597. You know, you tried.
The X. Nah, he it was
yo, shout out to the Breakfast Club for giving us entertainment like that, man. You know, keep making DMX like a fool, man. DMX, man, come on, man, get together, man. You know, yo, he did do a song with MGK. Apparently, it's, you know, getting a little buzz, somewhat. I think you know, he's still rapping like old DMX, which is cool, but you still gotta kind of adjust to the new time we're in. You know
just
what I mean?
Let DMX be DMX.
It's crazy because when you are a 90s rapper, it's, you know what I mean, unless you were consistent and if you just stop rapping and you come, it's that transition to get back. Like same thing happened to Mace, right? He went to church, right? Then he started scamming. The church board was like, look, you can't have the scams in here. You need to get up out of here. He left, came back as Murder Mace, G-Unit, right? And he had his hard time adjusting back.
Speaking about Mace, I heard Diddy.
We kind of know the.
I heard Diddy got him out of his contract finally now.
Oh, finally, yeah. Man. I mean, well, that's good. I don't know what's gonna happen with Mace. I don't know what he got to. You know, he can't rap like old Mace. I mean, we love old Mace.
Mace from Harlem.
Only Harlem nigga I know that's really rocking right now is Jim Jones, and that's because he's doing his little television joint. But shout out to Jim Jones, man.
You just disrespect the whole Harlem just now.
Who doing it right now?
ASAP Rocky doing.
Oh, time pause. Yeah.
No,
you're right.
We can't take that.
But who else?
Fab, but his girl is on the same shit.
I'm talking about Brooklyn. We got so many other people. We got Jay-Z representing.
Cookies, all of that. Y'all, let me freaking finish.
I'm sorry.
I gotta put all of y'all on blast right now.
She must be feeling good.
All right.
She on ecstasy right now.
Let's go.
Nah, I'm on that. I'm about to kick you in the throat. I gotta get a little violent. I had to get violent.
Listen, it's all right, Elle.
You be listening too much about Tyler the Creator.
Nah,
sorry. Yeah, right. Punch pregnant ladies and all that, and kill your best friend and all that craziness, Jay.
Yeah, I just don't listen. I guess that's what people rebel, like Tyler. No one wanted to listen about his pregnant baby.
Well, you got the mic now.
There you go.
Listening to you now.
It's open and you want to
talk about Tyler. Yes, but she's had to yell. Do I have to do that all the time?
Nah, it's not that you yell. You said that you was going to kick me in my throat, which is very violent. That's violent.
Remember, but
take this out. Okay.
Yeah, his girl or whatever was on the same show where all the Harlem World guys were on Living Hip Hop.
Mm-hmm.
She said,
and
the
so
Harlem
you
world.
Can't, because it's basically everybody, all the dips.
it was really like everybody. That. It was like that.
So it was just like, yeah, you can't knock one without knocking the other. And Fab wants his baby mom off that shit. She's like, no, right. Bitch, you leave. Get off the show.
Well,
right now.
Shout out to Fab and Joe Buttons. I feel like they slept with like every chick in the industry, practically, right? like all of them was like, oh yeah, I slept with Fab. Yeah, me and Fab had this. We had Lil Flame. We Fab. I was like, well, me and Buttons. Yeah, me and Joe.
It just goes back to the blame game with Kanye. He said it best.
Well, on that note, we're going.
But the bezel got this watch from the source. I love you, Fab.
Yo, I'm gonna say like, don't leave Fab alone, man. Fab, he trying, man. All right.
He is. That's
hey, yo,
really good though.
Regardless though, just a disclaimer for Brooklyn. You know what I'm saying we pretty much been doing it for so long. I mean, we can go down the list. I mean, Harlem is. They've been trying to keep up, but it's a no-brainer, really, right? When you work hard versus
Brooklyn.
When
you leave from here, what you gonna do? You gonna go home and pay the full, right?
Nope.
Yes, you is.
I'm actually gonna watch Notorious. You know what I'm saying? Cause I'm, you know, I'll watch Get Rich or Die Trying before I watch Pay the Full. No, I'll mess with you, man. Pay the Full was Pay the Full was a good movie. No, it was a good movie. You know what I'm saying? It was a good Harlem movie, you know. Of course, we all knew Cam was going to be
the snitch.
Of course. Cookies and apple juice.
Cookies
pink
and
sweaters.
Apple juice, cookies and apple juice.
And Range Rovers.
Hold on, I'm feeling some type of way. I got something against Harlem or something?
I just have something against Cam.
Damn. Yo, y'all had Cam representing y'all. What's going on with that? I don't really understand that.
What you mean, though? Like, Dipset had a lot of hits.
I feel like
all of the niggas that played in, for him to play in Paid in Full, he played his part.
You can't even sleep on Cam because when he was with Children of the Corn.
But now I can.
When he was with Children of the Corn, he was going north.
Damn.
When he was going north, he was going
west. Y'all had Big L.
Even when he had Dipset, he was still going up.
Big L's lyrics.
When Dipset came up, when Dipset popped off, that's when Cam started going downhill. That's my personal opinion.
He had the greats, though. AKA Big L, come on. Chill out.
I don't really know. Just Rock the Mic Radio, we here. What's going on? Just Rock the Mic Radio. Yo.
Yo.
What's good? What is?
Yo, this is Noah.
Oh, what's going on?
Noah?
What's going on? 18 Bells DVD.
Hey, yo, what's good, Noah?
Oh,
the infamous 18.
What you said, Noah? What is this?
His name is Noah.
Oh, Noah. Oh, my fault. I thought I just said Melvin. My fault, man. What's going on? Where you from, man? Noah?
Harlem.
Yeah.
All right, Harlem. Yeah. What's going on, man? So tell me about what's going on.
Shot
right?
Now.
What's up? You're shouting inside. You're an artist. What you do? What's up?
That's my cousin, bro.
Yeah. All right. Hey, why don't you just say that, man? You're like, yeah, you said, why don't you holler at your cousin? I said, what up, cuz? What's going on?
Yeah, he hanged up.
Yo. Noah, what up?
Noah's Ark.
Noah.
What?
You still there?
Yeah, he
hanged up. He gone. I'm sorry. See, that's the. Is he from Harlem? Is it? So he, man,
he probably had that connection.
Probably was talking about Ken. He probably ain't like that, man.
Oh shit.
Yo, well, listen, we get ready to go to break anyway, man. And yo, My favorite, I'm honest, man. My favorite mixtape right now was actually Underground mixtape, man. And it's by the VMS, man. We played their music here. I'm feeling it. You know,
and
he's
from Queens, right?
And they from Queens. And I'm going to keep it real. You know what I mean? Like, yo, music, I don't hate, man. Good music is good music. I've played the whole joint straight through. It's rocking. I'm about to play my favorite joint right now by VMS. It's called Flexing. Yeah.
Nice.
Sense a lot of tension, couldn't be a nigga ballin', but nobody wasn't hating when they peeped the nigga falling. I just bounce back and I'm Oh, you mad and that's tough luck. I'm pimping out, but you hugged up. I beat it down and you love her. Stay bitches, something they callin' me hustle man. They say I act funny, cause I never trust a man. Fuck him then. If you ride, let the strap buckle him. Pacify your swag, make the leeches wanna suck on him. No, no, not me though. My flow cracks straight kilo. They nervous, I'm like Debo. I'm fly than your hero. If you think I'm tricking, spray you up, then I wipe you out like I'm disinfecting kitchen germs. On a mission, I flip and earn, get money before I'm in the urn. 50-50, life is iffy, it's a give or take. My word is born, so every year my soul should get a cake. Blowing candles, throwing paper like it's ticket tape. Never sold a brick or a house, but I'm in real estate. Born in the real estate, grind in the real estate of mind when I'm getting cake. Flossing like I'm flipping weight. Flow crack, mix it go hard, think I'm whipping flake. In the whip, with your skank, leaning like she's sipping drinks.
bitches. Tricks, no strings, don't worry. Just wanna put it down. This may take a while, no need to rush. Just you and me, no stopping us. I don't come with no tricks, no strings, don't worry. Just wanna put it down tonight.
And we're back.
So we back in it. We back in this thing. That was
Yo, who was that though? That was
J Pounds, produced by me. You know what I'm
oh,
saying?
I thought yeah. that was, you know, he sounded like J Holiday.
Groovy,
like,
extra groovy track. Like
J Holiday.
Maybe
J
you
want
to put that on my playlist.
Yeah, that's called
right. Tonight. Right, I was thinking about
replay.
That as well.
You know, I got y'all.
Well, I'm about to get busy, but.
I might give you out of close.
I don't
want
no
to
lace, but that shit was all right, though. I didn't want to.
Keep it.
It's called Tonight by J Pounds, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So he's from Cali. Shout out to the kid, J Pounds, you know what I'm saying? Hollered at me. Yeah, I met the dude, man. You know, came through the studio, man. And, you know, we just
had made it. Magic.
Yep, pause, I think.
I knew.
Yeah,
it was
sounds a little weird. But, yeah, he's doing his thing, man. You know, anybody came all the way across the country to make, you know, do his thing, man. So he, you know, shout out to the cat, man. You know. Yeah, so back on this, man. You know, me and Latasha, we talked a little bit about monogamy.
Monogamy.
We talked about mahogany. No, and it's actually a good color. It's a nice color, actually. No,
what and whatnot.
Monogamy. I wanted to also get into chivalry. And is it dead? Right? Like, is chivalry dead? Right? Like, do you think? Like, you know what I mean? Like.
Want to start with Gramps?
Gramps, do you still hold doors for ladies? You know what I'm saying? You go on a date, you going to open the door for her? You know what I'm saying? Do you walk on the right side of the street? Do you know what I mean?
With me?
Yeah.
I think it's about timing. Like, you know, like.
We're talking about.
We going to the young ladies? You talk about timing. What exactly do you mean?
If I'm in the mood, then I do it. If I'm not, then I won't do it.
Yeah, that's real. That's real statement from a real G right there. He said, I'm in the mood. If I feel like
California thuggin', Harlem thuggin', Harlem, speak it up.
Yo, man, call us up, 718-369-0411. Ladies, we want to hear, you know what I'm saying? Is chivalry dead? Do you still want a man to show you some chivalry? Do you think...
cereal?
What's a cheap date? People, tell us what's up. Call us up. We want to hear y'all reaction.
Ain't nothing cheap nowadays, man. Like,
yo,
inflation and all that going on.
Wasn't nothing
like,
cheap to people back in the 1940s either, or the Depression.
So even McDonald's is starting to get expensive now. Like,
McDonald's, you know, you damn right, man. They went. I was like, they went button up in ties at McDonald's. Now they're like, look, man, we getting this money. We're going to look right when we serve you this meal.
We're going to need now a high school education to work here.
That's right. And they have a chef. Did you know McDonald's have a chef? I had no idea. I was like, what the heck? I saw like a little screen. You know how they had the screen.
I know.
McDonald's. And I was like, we have a chef.
You need a chef to flip burgers?
I had no idea, son. I was like, what does he exactly
chef
do?
Chef Boyardee.
You got to put the proper seasons on the burger, son. Like, the temperature for the fries got to be exactly right, son. Like, what's up?
I think that's like within any food handling place it should be. I hope.
I've heard some real hard stories about McDonald's.
Anybody that would
too,
hopefully man. Have an A grade average health code. I hope.
You know Gramps. What? You know what? I think the cheapest date I ever took somebody out was IHOP.
Oh,
I'm not gonna lie.
That's not bad though.
It's not bad.
Hey, shit. Especially
was
it nighttime and I was eating pancakes at like 2 a.m.
Nah, it was not. It was like I would say it was like
breakfast.
Nah, it wasn't breakfast.
It was like lunch?
Nah, it was like evening. Like,
I was
like
about to say, there's no more times in the 24-hour period.
Well, no, I'm just saying, it's a whole different level. It was like late night. Yeah,
but nah, it wasn't like, yeah.
That's like, yeah, it's IHOP, it's gangsta now.
But
you know
nah, it wasn't like, I wanted to do that. She wanted to do that.
Oh, so
I'm like,
all
right, she'll go, let's go.
So it's never a cheap date when the chick wants to do it. She can't ever call you. When the chick wants to do it,
be like, hey, you don't argue with her.
Yeah, if she say, hey, look, take me to White Castle, then that's not a cheap date. I'm just saying, right?
Hey, take
me to
the White Castle.
Take me to the Chinese bakery.
That's what she craves.
Fuck it, give me two lays. Two lays and a biscuit.
That's it. She could just be craving it.
So Kimo, let's flip it.
Uh oh, here we go.
Let's ask Elle. Where's the most expensive place he took a date?
Mm.
Let's flip it. Because we're always talking from the man, you know, the male perspective.
You tried to do this it last true. Time this and ran me over with a bus. But anyway.
I love you. That's
it was
fine.
A place, it was a place called Landry's. A place called Landry's Beats, since you asked the question. It was while I was in college. It was for my 18th birthday. The guy was in the military. He was a Marine. So he had just finished his, you know, basic training. I guess want to blow the basic training money. Yeah. Hey, I'm not going to stop him. Would you, if you was a woman, would you do it? Would you stop him if it was your birthday and he's taking you out?
Listen,
I want to blow my newly.
It depends on how much you spend.
Okay,
I'm a cat man,
crab legs,
so I don't have no problem.
The crab legs. You would spend at like Joe's Crab Shack for like maybe like 18 to 20. No, I said that you would spend at Joe's. Oh, it was okay. In comparison. Listen, Beats.
So
listen.
I'm about to say. So
how much before you?
How much you say your check was?
That's fine.
Like how much you say your check was?
Mine alone was $100.
So y'all looking at like $200 or word, right?
No,
yeah, you allowed.
It was just it was a seafood place. It was a seafood bar and grill.
Exactly.
Yeah, and it was wonderful. 5 stars.
So what happened
in the state of Alabama? Actually,
what happened?
So
what happened when you
what happened after the date?
You was on that.
See, I was hot when I was 18, but he I said hot. I was no. Let me tell you something.
You were,
I was
so
hot
wasn't.
When I was 18, but he wasn't hot that night.
I played
him to a little bit of left. I was young, like yo,
okay,
about to leave. In a Freeman on my birthday, you think I'm gonna hit on my cousins now?
That's crazy.
That's very.
I was a kid, yeah.
Oh God,
but he was like, oh, but in his mind, he was just like, next time I'll get that. Probably what was in his mind, and he never really did get it. So that was my story, Beats.
Oh, okay.
That was my story. Did you just touch my hair?
Bro, do you not know the rules? Do you not know the rules?
I'm like, Yo, B, I'm trying to look through her hands. I'm like, oh shit, Yo, B.
Nah. I felt a little. All I felt was just some soft caress.
Oh shit.
I was just like, I know that's just not. I know who's to the left of me right now, right? It's not the alcohol either. I know I feel some. I felt my hair like swaying to the back a little bit too. You probably saw him like, hey, you see me now, B?
Wow.
Yo, you gotta turn into some weird crazy shit. Come on, like it wasn't even like that, but nah.
Wow.
I'm just playing.
I can't joke.
Like the guy. Just
shout out
the guy.
Latasha, I see you right there, baby. Playing on your iPhone. Yeah. Is that an iPhone? Is that the, oh yeah, that's I thought I
can't recognize sure. The
she's I don't know because you know I thought that was the S3.
She's
know,
fancy.
S3 don't really look. I mean
they both got white.
They favor each other, but it ain't really.
Yeah, she's sitting down, you know, looking like she meditating right now and all that.
Well, her skull, kumbaya you know, position.
You know,
kumbaya,
looking very
Indian style.
Altruist and all that. You work out? Work out? Exercise? You don't do none of that? You natural fit, right?
So, hold on, since we're talking about Tasha, right? So
she can't speak for herself.
Me and Sean.
No,
it's a good thing. So me and Sean, we were walking into the studio. So I was like, yo, I didn't know Tasha used to get it in.
Yo.
So Sean was like, yeah. So I was like, yo, you saw?
She's going to walk on into the set right now in a second.
No, because this is and the reason why I'm saying this. So I saw her show.
Wait, hold on. What do you mean by show? Like
she had a show, like.
What do you mean by show? Like you got like the audience don't know what we're talking.
No,
about.
Like she had her own show.
Right.
You know, she was like a DVD kind of thing going on.
Oh, I
and she was going around interviewing people, and when I saw her, and I was like, I almost didn't recognize her.
Right.
And I was like, yo.
Yo. Yeah, the same thing happened to me. Right, I'm like, yo, is that's her?
So I kind of looked at her like or like differently.
Right.
Like,
right.
I didn't know her. So I was like, yo. So I started looking at her head. And I was really staring at her head, you know, she didn't have any hair.
Right, she had the blonde thing.
So I was like, oh, she got that Afrocentric kind of conservative thing going on at the time, you know, the earrings and all. And I was like, yo, if I didn't know her, I was like, yo, she's hot. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, so me and Sean was talking about that. He was like, yeah, she was getting it in and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, yo, that's what's up. Now she's on motherfucking Juzz Roc The Mic.
I know, right? It's a small world. Meditating and all that.
Yo, and it, I mean, you know what? It was definitely an honor, though, I got to say, to, you know, it's like to have her before I knew the full package, you know, that we was dealing with Latasha, you know what I mean? Like, I was like, and then I seen it later, and I was like, oh, wow, it's, you know, it's just a beautiful thing, you know what I mean? It, for those that, you know, that new viewers that are watching, you know what I mean, that don't know the journey of Latasha and Elle, man, it wasn't supposed to be both of them, man. It was supposed to be one or the other. We had a lot of contestants, but only one was supposed to get that spot.
Yeah.
And, you know, it was tough, man, because, you know, I like both of y'all, you know what I mean? I was, you know, they was confused the whole entire time. They didn't know what to do. I was like, yo, I think we should keep both of them. I knew it from the door. You know what I mean? They didn't want to film me on it.
Man,
that
stop lying.
He got the bleeds now. He said, I was feeling both of them.
I was feeling both of them.
I looked at Natasha. I was like,
exactly.
I held it down for both of y'all from day one.
Yeah,
when they walked in the door from day one, I was like, yo, them two. I don't even care about the rest of them. I knew. You know what I'm saying?
But yeah, that's kind of how.
A little bit.
Now, seriously. Because after finally, like, seeing everybody and taking it all in, like, the overall, we's like, yo, it's between those two.
Yeah. Special, and I still feel delighted.
We kind of let both of y'all go. I mean, one.
I wish I had some different sound effects. This guy, Gramps.
Yeah, right.
I'm saying, though, man, it's Saturday.
You always say that.
It's good. What does that mean? It means it's Saturday. It's the weekend.
I sometimes forget what day of the week it is. And so I'm always so busy. So he will remind us.
Well, you forget. Just be like, yo, Gramps. He'd be like, yo, it's Saturday. You'd be like, yeah, okay, so
it's
Saturday.
Sunday, and the next day is
Sunday. I'm like, what's tomorrow, girl? It's Sunday. I'm like, oh, shit. Yo, Gramps, son. Thank you so much, Gramps. Yo, you had it down for me. You know what I mean? Oh, man, yo. But, yeah, call us up, man. 718-369-0411. We want to see what's going on, man. You know, when we come back, right, I got something for y'all, man. I want to...
Marijuana?
I wish. But I want to... Matter of fact, since we're talking about that, you know, I actually have a Christmas tree of my own, and I would like y'all to see. Do you have that, Beatz, if you can? I want y'all to see my Christmas tree, man. I really do want y'all to see my Christmas tree if you can. I think, you know, this is how I celebrate Christmas, you know? And I figure, you know, why not, right? Why not do a big one?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You got a Christmas tree on a piece of paper, drawn on a piece of paper or some shit? And it says Merry Christmas.
I know what kind of tree you're talking about.
I mean, my kind of tree too.
Nah, you ain't talking about that type of tree. I know you ain't talking about that type of tree.
I mean, no, but it's.
I'm talking about that kind of tree. I don't know what kind of tree you're talking about.
My tree is very pleasant. I think if anybody would enjoy, you guys would, right?
But that's supposed to mean.
We just did an episode of Mary Jane, man. We were just talking about this for the past minute.
I forgot what that was going on at the show. I had to look at the show for me to remember what that was going on.
You was high that episode.
Bro. I know I was there. I was high up.
No, bump that. We just thank you. That's what I was imagining.
This is my Christmas tree. Thank you. You know what I mean? And this is
that's beautiful.
No decoration.
You ain't put no lights on it?
No ornaments in the.
This is one ornament.
You light it when you roll it up, player.
That's a big ass blunt.
They should have decorated it.
Take it by piece by piece, and by the time Christmas is over and the New Year is over, you should. I hope that's some exotic. I think it's great, right? Because
it'd be a shame if it is rain or something.
Like most people get live trees, right? And then they get the live tree. Then when it's time Christmas over, they got to take it and they got to tie it up and they got to throw it out and they got to sweep up all the debris.
What?
With this, you just roll it up each day. You roll it up. No?
No.
Oh, you bugging me.
Nah, but our family was ghetto fabulous. Well, we had that little plastic tree.
You know what? We had the Charlie Brown Christmas tree for a while, too. Yeah, and Charlie Brown Christmas
tree. That shit was popping, though. My plastic tree came with its own lights and it rotated. And the play is all music, yo. And the play is all music, yo. Like, my shit was popping. Had that shit for like 4 years.
Wow. I know. Well, one day that tree said, do.
Well, the greatest thing about this tree is that you roll one up each day, and then by the time Christmas is over, you know, people take it out, they'll leave it like the 6th of January or something like that. By the time that's over, your tree will be gone. You'll be done smoked it all. You know, you can invite friends over. You know, you don't have to draw on them, and then it's gone.
Why would you want to do that?
And you don't have to worry about, you know, cleaning up anything, and it'll all be gone. And, you know, it's boom. And you indulge.
After all of that, I would quit. After all of that,
nobody say you have to do it all
by
yourself.
The 1st of January in the New Year's resolution, be like, I did bad things.
Nah, yo, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. I can't.
It's time to become anew.
I can't take the picture of the marijuana by itself. Nah, I gotta jump in the picture and let people know, okay, like, this is me in the marijuana. Like, this is my man. Like, you know, this is me.
Oh, hey.
That's how it felt.
Oh, news, guys, people that's viewing, please, we need you to vote for us to be the best. New radio show, the hottest new hot show on SDWorldVision.com. Please vote, man. Come on. It's easy. The poll is right here. Right now, we were in first place.
We were.
Right now, we are in second place. You know what I mean? So we're, you know, we're at 46 votes opposed to 51.
On edge. It's about to be on edge.
On edge.
We need to just rock.
Yeah, so y'all need to just rock. So y'all need to vote.
You're fucking up.
Yo, y'all need to vote for us, man. Vote for us. Get these polls up. I mean, y'all do feel like we the hottest new show, right?
I thought people would.
I think we need more sex on the air.
I need to make sure y'all hit us up and vote.
We need some more models or something. Like,
so
somebody shaking it.
Okay. President of Uncut.
Every week we need a.
He needs to be the new president of BET Uncut.
Every week we need a girl.
Okay, can you cut off his microphone like you did? I mean. You know,
listen,
was so briskly done.
I got a treat for y'all though, man. I don't know if y'all know, man. We talked about Trinidad James, man. And talked about him last week. And
I say Jerome and I.
Case shot it and know. This dude got a $2 million deal, man. And Def Jam, they signed him, man. They were stupid enough to sign. I mean, they were smart enough to yeah. sign him. And
go Def Jam.
But yo. You know there was a little controversy, man. Jerome, man. You know, he took Jerome's swag. Well,
so is Martin Lawrence going to come after him? Probably with a pistol.
He definitely took Jerome's swag, man. I feel like it, man. So I got a little something, man. I
think he got a little lawsuit coming up that ass.
Possibly. This is possible.
This is Martin Lawrence's likeness. So he doesn't have any money now. Shout outs to Martin Lawrence, yo.
Yeah,
MC Hammer.
Why haven't
over the years he has to go back to Def Comedy.
You know, that's my cousin.
At least he ain't got to do what Bow Wow doing.
Martin Lawrence, in case people that may not know, Martin Lawrence is my cousin.
And Chris
actually.
Brown is mine.
Really? Damn.
Yeah, and they don't show no damn love. Now I'm saying, when the hell Martin call up the show? We done had the show for Martin Lawrence.
But it's okay. This is my first time actually admitting it.
Live. And yeah. I don't just people that know me.
Chris Brown is really your cousin, like, for real? You ain't playing? No BS?
No. Yeah, right. I have family in Virginia.
Wow.
For real?
Yes.
Wow.
Second cousin, last name.
It's going to be the last time we see you today, right?
Why he don't show you no love, yeah?
I don't know, and
but
I really
don't
care.
Your last name isn't Brown?
It doesn't have to be.
That's true.
No, just saying.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Marriage.
Sorry. Same thing with me. By marriage.
I want to be shouting that out too loud on the air, you know. Related Chris Brown.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna just give y'all a little snippet, man.
First
Jerome,
and only time.
Jerome, this is the only time you're gonna ever hear this, probably, and only place you're gonna hear this, man. This is Jerome featuring Trinidad James, Ogo Everything. I mean, we'll try to hear this, man. This is real. You know, you know?
James, gold all in my chain. mother, I'm sweating. Mama always told me, boy, count your blessings.
Count them all.
In God, I trust. So I kept counting them frankly.
Ball.
This is a Zoo Mix.
Yes,
Zoo Mix.
You're the finest girl I see.
The girls be hating when you step up on the scene. You be all up in my mind, like I seen you in my dream. I'm staring at you, thinking how you got up in them jeans. White feet, skin tight, true religion jeans. Your homegirls is bad, but you the baddest out of your team. Hips looking so tight, ass looking so mean. But your legs looking lonely, you should let me get in between. Cause I've never seen a girl as fine like you. Wake up every morning, get up on the grind like you. Virgo, I ain't never had a sign like you. Princess cut diamonds, they don't even shine like you. I've been all around the world, I've seen a lot of girls, but none of them was like you, none of them was like you. Always on my mind, one day you'll be mine, cause I really like you. One day I might like you. You're the finest girl I seen, you're the finest girl I seen. The finest girl I seen, yeah. Don't need no Maybelline. The finest girl I seen, the finest girl I seen, the finest girl I seen, don't need no Maybelline.
She the finest thing that I seen, tearing in heads when she hit that scene. Pretty face with a teeny weeny waist, got the dummy poking out them jeans. She the girl of my dreams, super freak in a sign of sin. She shorty bad, don't mean to brag, but she got that good pussy kind of swag. Make a nigga go bananas with it. Body thick when I swing a stick. Too legit to quit going hammer in it. Face and body so nice. Ass so dumb but her brain so bright. Yeah, her sex need anger management. Like why your pussy so tight? My ride or die, yeah, she by my side. And she rep the set like Zoo. And it's crazy sex when she hot and wet. And them sound effects is like ooh. Ain't scared, yeah, that's my boo. Might make me say I do, yeah, that's my type. When I lay that pipe, she coming twice. Call it deja vu. Swipe
it all around the world. I've seen a lot of girls, but none of them was like you, none of them was like you. Always on my mind, one day you'll be mine, cause I really like you, one day I might like you. The finest girl I seen, the finest girl I seen, the finest girl I seen, you need no Maybelline. The finest girl I seen, the finest girl I seen, the finest girl I seen,
who is that though?
Finest girl that I seen, baddest girl that I want. She keep it real with me, hold it still for me every time I got gone. Told her homie she a junk. He replied she too thick. I like my fluffy with a little bit of buffy and stuffy. I open up with this beat, then grind, wine, digging in it. Love it when I put my rhythm with it. Baby, you can come on. I don't want a small talk. I just want to get in your business with it. So tell me what you want to do. Baby, how you want to move? Cause you look like the wifey type. Let's see just what that life is like. She doing things she never done. All that means is she's having fun. I remember last time our favorite pastime turned her out. Now she runs. Baby girl, I'm not done. Getting buns to the sun. When I'm tired, get guns.
Yeah, they wanna know what we on. What you are, man? We on that BMS shit. Sense a lot of tension. Couldn't be a nigga ballin', but nobody wasn't hating when they peeped the nigga falling. I just bounce back and I'm Oh, you mad and that's tough luck. I'm pimping out, but you hugged up. I beat it down and you love her. Stay bitchin' something, they callin' me hustle man. They say I act funny cause I never trust a man. Fuck him then. If you ride, let the strap buckle him. Pacify your swag, make the leeches wanna suck on him. No, not me though. My flow cracks straight kilo. They nervous, I'm like Debo. I'm fly, they ain't your hero. If you think I'm trickin', H-E-double-L-N-O. PMS stuntin' like we OT in a rental. See us passing like a demo. Catch my drift like it's an ento. See ladies with potential, tell them hop up in the limo. Get it poppin' like a pimple. Oh, you ain't get the memo with that fresh breath. I'm all in their face, call me Dimples. Hey, shh,
getting perm. Chickens want beef, I got recipes that get you gone. Spray you up, then I wipe you out like I'm disinfecting kitchen germs. On a mission, I flip and earn, get money before I'm in the urn. 50-50, life is iffy, it's a give or take. My world is born, so every year my soul should get a cake. Blowing candles, throwing paper like it's ticket tape. Never sold a brick or a house, but I'm in real estate. Born in the real estate, grind in the real estate of mind. When I'm getting cake, flossing like I'm flipping weight. Flow crack, mix it go hard, think I'm whipping flake. In the whip, with your skank leaning like she's sipping drinks. Money talks, are you listening? To me it's yelling, but to you it's probably whispering. Paper piled up to the ceiling, I'm envisioning. You couldn't paint a better picture with an Instagram. I'm flexing, you see me, I'm flexing. You see me, I'm flexing. You see me, stunting like I'm on TV. I'm flexing, you see me, I'm flexing. You see me, I'm flexing. You see me, stunting like I'm on TV.
They saying wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, Mr. Walker. It's niggas out here hating and these bitches steady talking. Don't wanna see me in the sky, but rather view me in the coffin. Cause they know this nigga's ill, as if I'm sneezing and I'm coughing. But we give them reminders, we wouldn't think twice when you critics define us. Got the lead in this race so you can get behind us. They just trying to find us, I'm with a girl who got an ass. Boy, the size of E-Honda, that's big, you'll know who that is. Street fighter with my ride and go and grab the glasses. Or your magnifying glass to see the shit I'm trying to kick. I got love for everybody, but with a 10-foot stick or a pole, here I go. Jay-Z said, bubble on the low. This is my coming to age, and in a second, I'ma blow. To be the biggest in my city since that nigga Aljero. I got these shackles all around me with no fucking place to go. Somebody take them off. I got these cuffs on my brain, I'm just trying to maintain. I just wish someone would come and help me take them off. Cause that's what I'm trying to break them off. Now with somebody help me take them off. All these cuffs and these chains, cause I'm ready for a change. I've been trying, but I swear it's hard to shake them off. Now with somebody help me break them off. Saying wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, Mr. Walker. Old friends start to hate, extended family steady talking. How he hooked up with a bunch of college kids out there in Austin. I got him, his ledger got these women trying to stalk him. Oh no, that's why I'm only focused on my promo. The way I turn bitches down, you would think that I was homo, far from it. I just know it's money to be made. My mom about to retire and I'm trying to have her paid. That's the reason why I'm focused and I'm working like a slave to keep my trust in God. When shit gets hard, I know you probably feel it too, that's why you staying on your guard. But when life throws you a curveball, knock it off the park. I'm just trying to spit the real, tell you how I feel. And before I die, not leave a thing unsaid. Cause honestly, rap needs another nigga stunting. The way I need a hole in my head, I'm Gerald Walker. I got these cuffs on my brain, I'm just trying to maintain. I just wish someone would come and help me take them off. Cause that's what I'm trying to break them off. Now with somebody help me take them off. All these cuffs and these chains, cause I'm ready for a change. I've been trying, but I swear it's hard to shake them off. Now with somebody help me break them off. Somebody take them off. I got these cuffs on my brain, I'm just trying to maintain.
Fraud niggas, y'all niggas, that's that shit I don't like. Yo shit, make believe, rapping about my own life. Woo! That's Rand nigga, woo! Ric Flair nigga, woo! The power's in my hand nigga.
She went bro. You already know though. Only live once. That's a model. That's a yellow.
Roll something up when I take it out the stash. When I buy a house, I'ma pay straight cash. So I'ma flip and stack the dough, make it come back.
I take the girls in Napa, beat them to my mattress. A skeleton in my closet. It's probably when he dead and rapping.
She can have a Grammy, I still treat her like a nominee. Just need to know what that book like. So one time is fine with me.
Hey, Hey, yo, we on, we live.
There you go.
Latasha's here.
Yeah. What's up, guys?
What's up, Natasha?
Again, with the wrong name, though. Yeah, like,
I did that on purpose.
Yo, he always do
that. I don't feel so loved anymore. I don't feel so
well,
loved.
You know you loved on this. Yeah, you know what I mean? You know. It's all good. You know we've been holding it down. You know
I
mean?
Know. I feel like Gramps is new. Like, you know what I'm saying?
You know what? Like, who is this guy?
I earned this.
Like, I don't. You know.
Yo, Kemo, we're gonna have to like reconstruct your side because you got a lot of disaster.
We having a lot.
Right. Like, you know, it's not that I'm really clumsy, people.
Sean's microphone out, his headphone. You pulled everything out over there.
Well, unfortunately, everything is on my side. It's just, I'm at the disaster end right now.
Messing everything up.
It might be good. His microphone's out. I don't know. That might be kind of good.
That's me, though.
So if you guys are watching, just don't mind me looking crazy right now. I got into a fight with a Grey Goose bottle. Literally, the Grey Goose bottle won and cut me all up. So that's why I'm looking like Michael Jackson right now, the black version. But I feel good. I'm all right. I made it out alive. Oh, thank you. You guys say that a little loud so everybody can hear you.
I say you look all right, too.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. So sweet. So kind. Yo. Are we still working on the technical difficulties?
No, we still good. We still good. Go ahead.
I know you guys were talking about the cheap dates earlier, and I was laughing my behind off behind the scenes because y'all look crazy. Yeah, but I have a cheap date story.
I know you got a cheap date story. So what's going on?
I don't remember the guy's name either, but I was super young. I was super young. I think I was like 15.
Oh, okay. It's exceptional.
He wanted to take me to a movie theater all the way out in Canarsie just because
Brooklyn.
That's Brooklyn, right?
Yeah,
that's Brooklyn. Yeah.
I was like, oh, what? I forgot. So the reason why he wanted me to go all the way out there, and I'm from Queens, just because the movies was $5, and this is what he actually said. He's like, let's go all the way out there because it's $5 for that movie theater. We get there, the chairs are all torn up, it's just nasty and sticky, your little hot dog sellers got attitudes or whatever.
Well, it's $5.
Right. Right. So, of course, we passed the pizza shop. He'd rather me have a pizza because it's $1 versus the expensive maybe $3, $4 candy or whatnot inside.
Damn.
Pass on the pizza. We go to the movie theater, and he asked for the hot dog. And when he asked for a hot dog... No pause on that? You're not going to pause on that? Okay. When he asked...
He's slacking. I don't know what's going on.
He's slacking. When he asks for the hot dog, he looks at the girl and he goes, is it cheaper without the bun?
No, you're kidding me. You're kidding me.
Story. Devastation at its finest.
No, he really asked if it was cheaper without the bun.
That nigga sound mad.
That sound like some spoof. Yo, Juzz Roc The Mic Radio, we live. What's up?
What's up?
Yo, what's going on? Juzz Roc The Mic Radio.
He was just
there.
Yo.
Hello?
Yo, hello? What's up, man? What's going on? Who's this?
This is Mel.
DVZ. What's up, man? How's it going?
I'm chilling. How you doing?
We good, man. We here, man. We were just talking with Latasha, man, our co-host, man. We was going over her cheap dates, man, you know. Talking about how, you know, he said is it cheaper to get the hot dog without the bun, man, in the movie theater, man.
He embarrassed me at the movie theaters, man. Yeah,
it's pretty bad. It's pretty crazy, man. You ever take a chick?
Yeah, I know he did that out of love. I know he did that out of love. Hating nothing like that.
Yeah, you ever take a girl on a cheap date, man? Be real. It happens.
Yeah.
Maybe she wasn't worth it, right? She was. You like? She ain't worth my bread right now.
Now you try to save money, bro. You know it's recession.
Like, she's not worth it. That hurts a little.
Yo, I feel you, man. So what's going on? What's up with the DVD movement and all that? What's new?
Well, you know what I'm saying. Right now, man, I'm trying to do everything. You know what I'm saying. Me and Little Rex, we put together the new lines, and it's about to come out the second week of January.
We're about to
have brand new battles up at Black Star on 28th and Linux.
Okay, all right.
We're going to start lines, bring back up the new breed. Everybody that's going to be in is going to be the new breed. You know what I'm saying? We're going to start with some new pop lines to raise just like we did everybody else.
Okay, that's what's up, man. That's
he
cool.
just sound like a boss on the phone right now. You're talking mad hard. I'm gonna be out there in Lennox.
You can hear the boss swagger, man. It's just that real, man. That's what's up.
Yeah, I move around a lot. You know what I'm saying? I feel so much, and it's like I just want everybody just to, you know what I'm saying? Basically, get their fair share of, you know what I'm saying, whatever it is out there.
Okay, Yo, so people, real quick, I mean, we know what 18 Bars DVD is, but let everybody know what's up with 18 Bars and the whole DVD movement. What's going on?
18 Bars, right now, I'm close to 18 Bars. I just put out an 18 Bars rap battle series.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? Where I have, you know what I'm saying, the top guys that's doing far-fetched rap battles from New York. I had Marion Dillon Rats from Connecticut. I had my man Logic. He controlling our battle. Rap Battle League in Connecticut. Mm-hmm. I had my man Shaka Pitch. He controls the whole DMV from he controls everything that's going on downtown from Baltimore down. He controls all that. So you know, say I pick all the hardest rappers in their league and try to show everybody that there's other battlers out there than what you see right here.
Yes,
you know, don't just get stuck on these people is the best or the great, and there's a lot of other people that you never even heard of yet.
Right. Yo, well, check this out, man. We doing a freestyle battle here in March, man. We would love to have you a part of that, man. You know what I mean?
Let me know. Anything during the battle.
I got
a magazine I'm coming out with.
Okay.
In February. It's called Rap Battle Magazine. It's called War.
Nice, yo. So that'd be perfect, man, to include you in that, man. It's going to be crazy. It's the March Madness freestyle battle, man. So it's going to be crazy. So we definitely want to include you in that, man. We probably could come up with a crazy rise or something,
definitely,
man.
Definitely
going to
part of that. Definitely
yeah,
so
we, we're going to sit down and chop it up with that, man, yo. Can't go without saying, man, December 27th, man, we'd love to see you come through. We got the showcase, man, the last show of the year. So it's going to be crazy, man. If you can make it, that'd be good luck, man. If not, man, it's all
love. I want to make it.
Yeah.
Yo, you I like that your voice goes up a few octaves.
Right.
I want to make it.
You're a smart man, so he said, I want to make it. He must know, man. Because we put people on blast that don't show up to the show, man. We blast them.
I want to make it, man. Please, me. I will make it, man. I will be honest with you. So, you know how I do it. I will bring my ear to her from Crack DVD.
Nice. That's what's up, man.
I will bring him there. I will listen to other media outlets so niggas can get this in. All type of shit going. I'm into networking.
Yo, so, man, I mean, you got the DVD going on, man, but do you spit? Do you rap? Do you rap? I mean, you know you got the battle. You got everybody battling. You in charge of that, but do you rap yourself?
Nah, I just love the art
you
so
just
much.
Love it. That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying? I just love the art of rap so much. You know what I'm saying? When I was growing up, I was growing up before I rap was started. You know what I'm saying? I was growing up in Grand Projects on 125th in Amsterdam. No. So that's the home of the Steelers 4.
Okay.
Steelers 4 is the first rap group that was signed to a major label.
Right, okay.
Let's go.
That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying?
It's history right there.
Jesus around the block. These are on the block. You know, so these are like great type niggas that niggas got their styles and you just said, I'm gonna do rapping behind these type of niggas.
Yo, Kimo, you taking notes?
We gotta learn from this guy.
Listen, man, I'm always taking notes, man. I'm always learning, man. Anybody with more experience and more wisdom, I'm always. That's how you get wiser, man. Real talk. Yeah. You taking notes, Gramps?
I'm learning. I did a video thing for Chivalry, some history in the show, his history, basically, you know what I'm saying? Because Chivalry, he's the first rapper that was signed on Def Jam.
Right, I know,
the
I remember.
The first rapper that made a million, sold a million copies of his record on Def Jam that gave the light to LL and all these artists right now that's on Def Jam.
Right, for sure, man. Well, listen, man, look, let everybody know, man, because we got to get back to the show, man. But I want you to let everybody know where they can find you at and where they can follow the DVD. If they want to get down with it, let them know what's up, where they can link up at.
Well, basically, you can hit me up on Facebook, Melvin Walker, 18 Bars.
Mm-hmm.
You can hit me, you can look at my videos on YouTube. Just Google 18 Bars. You see where I'm at. You never know what state I might be in, what town I'm in, or whatever it is I'm doing.
All right,
you basically have to get where I'm at.
That's what's up, man. Well, thanks, man. Thanks for calling us up. Just Rock the Mic Radio, man.
Thank you.
No problem. Nice to meet you. I hope I get to see your faces.
Yeah, you will, man. Definitely, man. December 27th.
All right, man. You're showing me where you're at, my dude.
No doubt. Salute.
Yo, it felt mad good. You know, the Harlem energy just coming around, man. Like, you know.
Yo,
I love
Harlem.
A happy and excited hood dude.
Oh, man. Oh, so you know what you like now.
Here we go.
You've been trying to figure that out since you didn't join the team. Let's Rock the Mic Radio. What's going on? We here.
Yo.
Yo.
What's
this?
What up, man? This just Rock the Radio?
Yeah.
This Burger King, can I take your order, please?
Domino's Pizza.
What's good, y'all? What's happening tonight?
Shit, what's happening with you, bro?
What you doing? Chilling, man. What? Just got up from work.
Who is this? Who is this?
Hold on. Where you work at?
Where I work at?
Yeah.
I can't get all my personal information.
Just send the discounts to justrockthemic@gmail.com.
That's it.
All we're really concerned about
for
the holidays.
All right. We can work with that.
Who we talking to? Who is this?
Oh, y'all talking to Moolah, man.
Moolah!
I knew that voice sounded familiar, man.
What up, y'all?
Yo, where you been at, man? At least you came here, you bodied the freestyle, set the Rock the Mic session that we do. You know what I mean? You held it down for Gramps.
Yeah, I see that. That just had me proud.
You know what I mean?
You
said you gave us your word you're going to come to the showcase. We put you on blast.
Damn.
And you didn't come, but it was all love. You know, we had to do it. Yeah, man, and then we didn't see, and everybody was just that question mark in everybody's head, like, where's Moolah, man? Where's that kid that came here and
came
with the balls?
Kimo, that's light skin bringing?
That's light skin. Yeah.
Light skin bringing light skin back.
That's
light
skin bringing light skin back. It was good, man. Where you been at? Where you been hiding at?
Yo, honestly, man, I've been doing my thing, man. You know, I still going to the studio. It's just, you know how work kind of get crazy, man. You know, you got to make money somehow.
I hear that, man.
Take care of the person. Grind is everything. I feel you.
Yeah, man. But, you know, I was trying to, I'm Devin, what's the next showcase, man? I'm trying to come up there.
Yo, Moolah. Like, yo, I don't want to put you on blast twice, man. I really don't, man. We actually like you, man. We don't want to.
The
rules is rules, man. Yo, listen, this is your last chance to be in the 2012 Just Rock the Mic Showcase, man. All right, you ready?
What's the day, yo? What's the date?
The 27th, man. That's this Thursday coming up, man. Recoup this Lounge,
Thursday.
210 Riverton Street. Yeah, I mean, bring your ID, because, you know, they ain't letting you in. They real strict about that, man. So come through, man, for real. You know what I mean? You coming?
Yeah, man, I'm going to be there for sure.
I don't know, man. You don't sound too sure about that. Now you say, yo, I'm gonna have to put you on blast.
You gotta put some confidence in that one.
Yeah, man. Listen.
Yeah, I'm gonna beat it, man. That's Moolah.
Yo, Moolah, real quick, man. We gotta keep it moving, man. But yo, hit us with a freestyle, man. You know how we do. We can't let you go without dropping some balls. So let's go. Acapella, let's go.
You want me to hear a little freestyle? All right. Y'all ready for this, man?
Let's go, man.
Yo, watch out, yo.
Punking somebody in the street.
Yeah, man. So here, so I'm gonna spit something for y'all, man.
Let's go.
Oh my.
Say, yo, I think I need a lap dance. Run that mouth about that dick. Treat it like some track pants. Go ahead and sweat my shit. Crash course shop. Moolah, welcome to my body shop. Wax on, wax off. Service on Miyagi, yeah. Speaking on a boss status. Sleeping through a 9-to-5. Conversate as I penetrate. That's just 69. Prima Donna chipping check, Rari door shopping next, clutch ass, Martin sex. Oh, did I mention sex? What the fuck? I'm the one she fucked, doing sit ups on my stick shift. When the car pulling up, do donuts since she loved tricks. Trick it out, magician, embodied it, mortician. Had contact on her iPhone, that's word to my eyewitness. Late for a workout, that means you can't fuck with me and my paparazzi Nazi on Jules. Signing on TMZ.
All right. Moolah, that was that shot, Moolah. Yeah. That's what's up, man. Thanks for calling us up, man. Yo, Just Rock the Mic Radio.
And put some Moolah in your Just Rock the Mic holiday.
Hold on.
Please.
Yo, let them know where you can find you at, though.
Yeah, let them know.
Yo, that's Shaw Moolah, man, at www.twitter.com/Shaw_Moolah. The first time I'm giving out my government, y'all can hit me up on Facebook under Shawn Chavez, man. That's Chavez, end with a Z, as in zebra, man.
Okay.
Didn't your family have a drug ring or something like that? Is that the wrong? Did I get the right last name? No.
Wow.
Okay. I was just checking. I just wanted to see.
Hey, yo, Moolah.
Yo.
Yo, you smoke?
Nah, stop, man. Quit that life.
Cool.
Yo, man.
Oh, sorry.
How y'all feel, man? The world. We still here, y'all. We still here.
That's what's up, more or less. All right. Yeah. So, all right, man. So, we're going to definitely holler at you, man. Definitely give us a call later on. I'm going to see us on the 27th, all right?
Let's go.
All right. He ended
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you be cutting on people quick, yeah, man. Be you gotta put a signal up or something. Like,
no, that's Sean. Sean was controlling the phone.
Oh, damn. So he was like,
he like, click. Like, yeah. Sean got it. Get out.
Sean has no compassion for nobody. That's just, man. Just horrible, man. All right, man. We're going to keep it moving, man. So what's up, man? I know you was getting into your day. I mean, people just kept calling while you was getting into that, man. But that was, so is there anything else that, I mean, made that day the nightmare with that? You know, as far as, I mean, the last thing we were talking about was, you know, he had to ask about the hot dog with the...
He tried, oh, my bad, my cheap date.
Yeah.
To top it off, after he was cheap the entire time, it was really cold out. The winter was just starting. Mm. So he tried to lean in for a kiss, and I had to, like, reject that because he had the little, like, winter scabs on his lips, like the little chap, like...
So you was cool with him saying that, you know, if you get a discount for the bun. So you was cool with that, basically.
See,
you say the only reason he ain't give a kiss because he had the scabs on his lips and all that.
Oh,
so,
man.
I'm just saying, like, you must have been still cool.
I knew him. I wasn't going to see him again, so regardless, like...
Oh, so you just trying to be nice to give him a courtesy kiss.
I wasn't going to kiss him, but what made it even more solidified was the fact that his lips were awful and gross.
So why ain't giving him no Blistex around?
So he could put his dried, chapped, scabbed up lips on my lips?
You have some nice lips on your lips. I'm just
saying.
You
can go around sharing your Blistex if you want to. See what you catch.
Hey,
I don't like niggas, so I like females. Bro.
Hey, I mean, well, say, that don't mean that she could have something could be going on with her lips too, man. You know?
Isn't there a lookalike of Gramps online doing something kind of weird?
You know what? There actually is. What, you know, your lookalike.
Your
Trey
lookalike
Songz,
is doing
man.
Something foul online.
He's doing something real foul, man. And I, you know what? It broke my heart. It didn't break my heart actually. It actually tickled me a little bit. I thought it was very funny because so many ladies throw themselves at this dude, man.
What the fuck is he doing?
I'm gonna just show you. I'm gonna just show y'all, man. I can't even. Yo, Beatz, whenever you ready, man. This is bad, right? Like you don't ever want. Like what is he? Is he kissing a lock and like that's really? Come on.
I don't believe that's Trey.
Well, who is it? That damn like he really.
I don't
like
believe
Trey, that
that's Trey.
Really?
That might be his porn look.
You can't even say that's Photoshop. Like people, that's fucking. You can't even say that's Photoshop, man. You know what I'm saying? It looks like Mr. Stay Your Girl has turned to Mr. Stay Your
Gramps
Man.
If Gramps had a little curly fade and the flash was right, wouldn't be able to tell either. You just can't throw people's names or something like that.
Listen.
The other guy looks like Terrence J. The other guy looks like Trey Songz. Shit. You just know that.
Oh,
I just
threw Terrence under the bus.
Why you had to do that? No, I trusted. That's Trey Songz. Screw that. End of story. Bottom line.
I don't believe it.
Well, you know, I mean, it's
I have a cup of unfertilized eggs reserved for him, and y'all going to throw this picture up right now.
Well, he'll probably do it for his price, you know. You know, just because he, you know, lock lips with dude don't mean he don't like the ladies, you know.
I don't believe it.
It's just bad that, you know, you got to see that, man. I mean, it makes me laugh, actually, because I knew the whole time.
That really hurts.
Elle said Gray Songz. He's not training him. He's Gray Songz.
Gray Songz.
He's a porn dude.
Yeah. Well, you know.
He's lookalike.
Yeah. Well.
Gay porn name.
To be honest with you, man, I'm not even surprised. Like, if that.
Yeah, industry, right. You know, it's a lot of that going on in the industry, man. So.
Exactly.
Man. You know, it ain't a big thing, man. You know, I don't know if you've seen the pic with Diddy and Ross. But I mean,
guys are reaching.
No, I'm not reaching. It's an actual. Here's the thing.
I saw the photo.
That could be just a quick flash. I could, you know, even that you can be like, well, maybe that's not exactly what it seemed like.
What happened with Diddy?
I'm gonna get that picture for you.
Pretty much, those two were on stage at a concert. You know how you give a dap, you give a hug, and you kind of like pull away, or somebody turns their head too fast, or something happens. Somebody took a photo of just that exact moment when they were changing their faces or whatever they was, and their lips like kind of grazed past each other, like coming out of the hug. They like turned their heads and their lips like grazed and like touched a little, and then somebody caught that perfect moment and were like, "Oh, make out."
Yo, but if you look at the picture, man, it really looks like,
And that's not even lips. That's their noses. Oh,
but if they live too close, like, for comfort, though, like, I ain't really gonna be that close for you. Like, I'm sending this to you, man. Like, this is crazy. Like,
Shout out to Media Takeout for the daily tomfoolery and ignorance. It's so good. So good.
Yo, in the meantime, we're gonna take this call, man. But seriously, that, like, shout out to Media Takeout.
That shit was disgusting.
For that.
Usher was disgusting.
You know, Diddy said he was wrestling Usher when he was a kid for some Frosted Flakes.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. You
want
to talk to him? Huh?
Uh-oh. Sean having a sexy conversation on the phone. Hold on.
What's up? Uh-oh. Just rocked the mic radio. What's up, Gramps' mom? What's up? Hey. Hello?
Hello.
Hey, how you doing? Is this Graham's mom?
It's Chris' mom, yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Chris, I'm sorry.
Is that short for Christopher?
Yeah,
Christopher. I'm sorry, Christopher.
Is it
we call him Gramps, you know. So.
We call him Miss Thomas.
We just call him Gramps.
We call him Gramps. I'm sorry. Christopher.
Yeah, how you doing, she don't know who her son is when you leave her.
She don't know who her.
Hey, y'all going to stop talking to my mother like that.
How you doing? Look, we're talking to her. I'm sorry. Would you like me to call you? What can I call you? Can I call you?
Call me?
Yes, what can I call you? What would be the proper?
Big D.
Huh?
Big D.
Is it cool? Are we being disrespectful to you in any way? I just want to make sure. You know, we just.
I would never.
We would never ever disrespect. All right, that's cool.
It sounds like you're having a happy Christmas, good time. Yeah,
yeah, we having a good time.
Y'all got a good jolly going on over there.
We try to have a good time.
I'm over here frying some chicken and bacon some.
You said what now?
Oh, we coming over?
And bacon some.
Oh, yeah. What's up with you, bacon? We hungry.
I know you could feed the crew.
Mm-hmm.
Well, only one of you eating is me and my daughter, and I always cook more than enough.
Oh,
so
okay.
We still now.
Oh, we coming. We coming.
I don't have no company, so I'm good.
Oh, I know that's right.
That's what's up.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I will have leftovers for tomorrow. Maybe I don't have to cook tomorrow.
Nice.
Everybody ain't
coming
to eat now. Nice. I'm a little intimidated. I'm always afraid to meet somebody's parents.
Right. That's always.
I feel like I'm in trouble. I'm like, hi, Mrs.
Well, since you're in the air, I think it'd be interesting to actually see what you think about cheap dates. Because we was talking.
Yes, mama.
You see, you know, I mean, you know, you clearly have more experience than us, so we want to see, like, you know, what do you think? I mean, can you tell us?
Give me that. I didn't even hear the question.
Can you tell us?
You have to enunciate chemistry.
I'm sorry. You know, it's the Brooklyn in me. I can't help it.
Are y'all from Brooklyn?
Well, not
he
all
is.
Of us. There's Brooklyn. There's Queens.
Are you from Brooklyn?
Yeah, he from Brooklyn.
I don't go to Brooklyn that much.
It's all right. Most people.
Digital high five.
It's all right. It's
okay. I mean, I like Brooklyn parties. I did a couple of years ago.
That's cool.
I never got to go back.
Okay.
If I go to Brooklyn, I would like to go to a live party. That's about it.
Okay. Well, I've got to ask you, what is the cheapest date that you've been on? Can you name it? Or a cheap date that you've been on?
A cheap date that I've been on?
Yes.
Where did they take me?
Huh?
Yeah.
Where did they take me?
Yeah, that was probably cheap. Or maybe just a bad date.
A cheap date? To buy a Frankfurter from the Frankfurter stand.
Nice.
Wait. That was like the meal destination. Like, girl, I'm gonna take you to go eat. Two hot dogs, please.
And they took me to the you know, one of those stands. They got the two for a dollar something.
Ooh, they got the discount stand.
Wow.
Yeah.
We don't even get hot dogs for a dollar anymore.
Wow.
Right on the corner.
Nice.
And what did you say? Were you very thankful when you received your hot dog? Were you, like, cursing him out? What did you do?
You went to Papaya's?
Big
D, you went to Papaya's?
That's all you could afford it. It was all good. I ate it, though.
Right?
And talk shit about it.
Yo, I got to say this. I definitely see where Christopher gets it from. I definitely see. We call him Gramps, though. You know what I'm saying? I see where Gramps get it from. You know what I mean? Yeah, you ain't tell your mom we call you Gramps, man.
No, man.
Yes.
He just sitting there like a little puppy dog now in the car and looking all.
They complain too much. They complain too much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I see that. The apple don't fall too far from the tree, man. The sense of humor is funny, man.
I'm very funny, so.
I see.
We can tell.
People call me the joke for the day.
That's what's hilarious. Up.
Yeah. Well, just before, to make them laugh. Make them laugh.
Before we go, Big D, you got to give us some bars.
Well, my birthday.
You got to give us a freestyle.
Stupid, man.
My birthday is coming up. I'll take a bottle. It's January the 7th.
You got that, Gramps? Gramps, I'm sorry, Chris got you.
Yeah. So what's up? You gonna kick a freestyle for us? You gonna spit something?
Just give us like a little rap.
What you talking about? Maybe spit something?
Yeah, I want you to spit something. I want you to hear something.
Is really funny.
This is just Rock the Mic Radio. You gotta rock
the mic.
Give
us like two bars.
We got something nice, something light. Like just give us one rhyme, just real quick.
You funny.
Just curse him out. Just
she's
say,
not,
come on,
she's
come on.
She's not doing it.
Just curse she's him out, man. Just curse
nah,
him
I ain't going to do that.
Right, but we are coming up for the chicken, though, so maybe we just make a few extra wings.
Just put my plate to the side, though.
He'll never come.
Damn. She just put two on blast.
He's always say he's coming. He never come, but I saw his text. He's talking about calling the station.
Oh.
So that's all the text up for what?
Gramps, man.
He's so mad.
I was missing my mother.
You know, he's not mad at him, so he's gonna ask you to call the station.
Come on, Gramps.
I wanted to talk to my mom. That's why I'm mad. I loved it to her. I loved it.
Yeah, I hope you got that Christmas gift.
Ooh. I do, but you gonna get it after
Christmas.
And
then the bottle on January
8th. And then the bottle on the 7th. Oh, man.
Hold on, you want a Christmas gift?
Yeah, and my birthday is January 7th, yeah.
Wow!
I had you. You didn't have me.
So, well, big thing. We gotta keep it moving on the show. But thanks for calling us up. This is Just Rock the Mic Radio. Thanks for giving us a call. And yeah. We gonna make sure he give you that gift. And
all them
gifts. And he gonna make sure we gonna show up too, man.
And what's your name again, sir?
My name is Kemostry.
And I'm Latasha.
Hi, Latasha. He got a nice voice. I hope he look good with that voice.
Oh. on that note, thank you. I appreciate it. I thank you.
All right, you have a nice Brooklyn.
You too. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Get you that digital love hook
Yo,
up.
You know what? It's just like Gramps, though, right? Right? Doesn't Gramps say the same thing?
Yep.
Right? You got a nice voice. Any girl that calls up, he's like, she got a nice voice. Yeah. You sound sexy. I'm telling you, it's like, I understand now, man. I just learned
All
something about
sense.
You, man. I understand that.
All makes sense.
I understand that.
Your grandpa's red.
Right, this red. I've never seen him so quiet.
I know, right?
He was in red form.
Oh. I've never seen him so vulnerable in the corner.
He's like, damn, why'd I do it?
You told her to call up.
Call me on the radio, Mom.
Hey, listen, we got Zoo Muzik group in the building, man. We just played their song, man. Find This Girl, man. It, dope, man. We playing it for a few times, man. Since they released it to us, man. The video was crazy. Make sure you go check that on YouTube, man. Zoo Muzik group, Find This Girl.
Were those like personal friends of you guys, like the girls who were? They were okay. That's all.
Okay.
There must be a reason for that question.
I'm trying to figure that question.
Exactly right. Like a plug or something.
Y'all all look really nice today, though. We've been sitting here chilling with us. Y'all all look real good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit.
Better watch out for this one.
Yo, listen, though. Listen, she had a couple of drinks in her, too. So
Yeah. Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah, so, hey, you know, you never know.
Anyway,
we love you. Yo, listen, it's the holiday times, right? So I had to do it, man. Listen, I got one for you.
Aww.
You know what I mean? Yo, here you go, man. Hold that.
I don't know if I could get that over her curls.
Yeah. Listen, but I got a project for y'all, man. I want to see y'all do something. Look, don't put it on yet, right?
Sorry, boss.
I want to see your skills, man. I want to see you write your name. See how skillful you are on the hat. Can you do it?
Write my name in glitter on the hat?
Do it, yeah. Can you do it?
I took arts and crafts. I want to see
how nice you are, man. I'm taking you back to kindergarten. I'm taking you back.
I feel assaulted, bro. You trying to say we slow or something? We can't write your name on a hat?
I'm just saying, you know? It may seem easy, but you're not really
that
using the
pen. That means you effed this up before.
This shit do feel like.
And you was like, damn.
It seems easy. It may seem easy.
This shit
just
do feel like some
velour
shit, though. Like, where you
been
this shit?
Okay, yeah. It's the gap. It's the gap, you know what I'm saying?
This,
you know?
This is going to, like.
Yeah, yeah. Pick big color pen.
You sure you didn't get this from 99 cents?
Caller.
Oh, yeah.
I would have got this from 99 cents, though. I don't like that. Like,
it's crazy. It's crazy in here right now.
Oh, Bella, hold on.
It's crazy.
Yeah. Oh, whoa, whoa.
Bella, no
lie. Bella, just rock the mic radio. Bella, we've been waiting for your call, girl. Oh, man, I've been seeing you on Facebook.
Oh, shit,
I've been seeing you got somebody to put on blast.
Yeah, I got a lot of things.
Hold on, Bella. Yo, where you from, Bella?
And is you light skin?
Let him know where you from, where you Bella. From? Let him know.
I'm from Brooklyn.
Of course.
All day,
you ain't got to get kind of light on us because, you know, you sounded like a little nervous when you say you from Brooklyn. Like, you dug at somebody or something? I said you kind of got light when you say you from Brooklyn. Like, you was scared or something? Like, what's up?
No, not like, even. How'd that
light?
I said BK all day.
There you go.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Sound
like a
light. Sound like you whispering shit. You sound like you was whispering on the phone or something. Like, not supposed to be on the phone right now or something?
No, I'm good.
Oh,
all
right, just making sure.
Oh, yeah, he'd like to meet you on
right
the
now, new one. Right, the new man. All
right.
Okay, so what's up, Bella? I mean, we want to hear what's going on. So what you got to tell us?
Well, let's see. Where can we start?
Start from the very
beginning.
You're
in Flatbush, right? You know what Flatbush is?
Well, I'm in Flatbush, you know.
Well, so then that means you definitely have a lot of listeners that are in Flatbush.
Indeed. What's up? We got everybody listening. What's going on?
Well, there's this guy that's really, really known in Flatbush. Everybody calls him Butter. His name is Alvin Elder.
Oh, sure. Say that one more time.
He lives on 54th Street.
Damn!
No,
wait, Paul.
No,
wait, hold on. One more time. That address, we need that one more time.
The name and the address, one more again.
His name is Alvin Elder. Everybody calls him Butter or Ra. He lives on 54th.
Like, they call him
Butter.
Yo, we need him to call in too, yo. Like,
and what road?
And Clarendon Road.
Oh, man. And everybody calls him Bella like you? Like your name, Bella?
Butter.
No, my name is Bella. They call him Butter.
I thought they called him Bella like, you know, like you know, because, you know, you're Bella and that probably was your piece. So, you know. But anyway, go ahead.
Well, yeah. So, he lived over there. We dated each other for about 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so at the end of our relationship, a girl calls me and tells me mm-hmm. that she's 17 years old mm-hmm. and he is 30.
Ooh.
She's 17. She calls my phone. And she's like, well, she calls my house phone because we live together. She's like, well, I've been having sex with your husband for about a year now. And he gave me chlamydia. So I'm like, you passing nasty STDs to insecure little girls. That's how you guys are. I think that's the big thing of love. So straight past STDs.
Hold on, Bella. Do this guy know where you live at?
No, he don't know where I live at. I used to live with him. He doesn't know where I live at. And even if he did, I don't care.
Okay, Brooklyn.
Oh,
shit.
It was a video, so he won't try to do it.
Wow.
Yeah,
so sex education.
Please proceed. Please.
So you said at 17.
His name is Roy Jr. R-O-Y.
Damn. Yo, you really, you must really don't like this guy.
I don't. Oh. In the picture, it's him. And he got a New York Yankee fitted on.
Oh.
That's his picture.
Damn.
His ass. Tell him.
She throwing profile pictures.
I'm gonna blast him. I'm gonna make flyers with a picture of his face, and I'm gonna write, "I like having sex with little girls."
Oh.
And I'm gonna put.
Alright, but we gotta be. Alright. Oh, for his.
I have a question.
For his defense, though. Is he not the only guy that mess with young girls, though? Come on.
But
we got Russell Simmons out here. He,
but,
you know,
is my mic on?
He's 30 years old.
Look at Russell Simmons. Look at
who
he got
to
know. He was like 30 years old. She was like in her teens. Like,
Yo, but Gramps,
she was 19 to be exact.
I have a question.
Bro, it don't matter. She was still in her teens.
Bella, I'm not, and Bella, I'm gonna ask you a question, and I'm not saying this to try to embarrass you, play you X, Y, and Z. I'm not trying to get at you at all. But God forbid, I hope he didn't give it to you either.
Oh, right? Yeah, that's how we found out, because we went to the doctor together.
No.
Oh,
yeah.
Damn. She keeping it.
But that's, I'm good. I cleared that up or whatever. But I'm pretty sure he still messes with the same girl, and damn. I'm pretty sure they're still passionate back and forth.
Yeah, that's real. Shout out to you, man.
But you good, though, right?
I'm a real ass person. Yeah, I'm good money. I live in the doctor's office.
That's what's up.
No, that's what's up, yo.
You know, I don't know.
So, yo, I feel for you. Chlamydia is an awful gift for the holidays.
So, what Bella look like?
Yo, Bella.
That is an awful gift.
Bella looks like exactly what the name sounds like, man. Bella is a dime, man. I don't understand.
You got a picture of her?
She likes him.
Where she at?
Yeah, we got pictures of Bella, man. She might just be our pick of the week, man.
Let me see her. Let me see how she looks. You do got a nice voice though.
Bella, she stands by the name, man.
You kind of sound like you know you little voluptuous.
So Bella's.
Oh, you're there. So cute, Bella.
Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you.
Yeah, you really are. Uh huh. Yeah, so you know she keep it together, man. I don't understand what this dude would
damn,
even.
Damn, son.
I don't know.
Let them have a one-on-one session right now. Like, let them talk right now.
Who?
You
talk?
And Bella. You someone you like.
I was just saying
she had
a picture with her. You had the picture with the cheetah pants on. I was saying I would pull over because that ass too fat.
She took it back. You know what I mean?
She cheating right now.
Are you sending that to me, man? What's going on?
Yeah, I'm sending it to you right now, man. Come on, man. You know I got you, man.
That's something we can pass around.
Wait a minute. We're not going to send beef. He over some shit, yo. Right, Beatz?
Huh?
What exclusive songs be saying? What's good?
Oh, yeah. He'll be showing no love with the new music.
I'm saying, top secret. I got some shit on the rack.
Yeah, so Bella, anything else you want to add to that? Because we gotta keep it moving. But we want to know if there's anything else you want to add that might be real important to this message.
Same guy. I pay for everything.
Mm-hmm.
Everything.
Mm-hmm.
Still living at home with his mom.
Oh.
Still never had no job, never held a job.
He is a Tommy.
Never graduated high school.
Yo, you know what we need to do, man? I don't mean to cut you off, but we need to have these people that's getting put on blast come and defend themselves. We need to have them to come
genius.
And defend themselves, man.
We should.
Because there's always two sides of the story. I'm not saying that what you're saying ain't true, but there's always two sides of the story. I always like to hear this.
Well, hit him up. See if you get him on air.
I don't have Roy
Jr. Facebook.
No, Gramps, what you need to ask is what attracted her to him? And then, because you always know it's turmoil at the end, and then they they're going to say, oh, he was this, he didn't have that, he didn't, So what exactly made you attract? What was so attractive about him, Bella? Why you started messing with him?
Well, in the beginning, it was like a fun situation. It was like, oh, I'm this and I'm that. He had a nice little car, whatever. And he was like, I'm this and I'm that, and I'm that nigga, and da 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 da. And I was attracted to that, so I was like, oh, okay, I like that. He's a boss or whatever. And I was really looking for something that he. I was really looking for something that I shouldn't be looking for anyway, because money is everything. But I felt like, he could really take care of me. So I was like, okay, I'm going to mess with it. And then little by little, everything sort of started coming out. And I was already so deep in the relationship that I was like, why leave now, It don't make no sense. I really care about the person.
So you want a sugar daddy, basically. That's what you want.
That's what I thought it was gonna turn into.
See, that's what you fucked up.
Ain't nothing to fear.
I want to fall in love.
Ain't nothing ever to fear.
That's what you fucked up at. Like, you can't go for the sugar daddy like that. Like, if you trying to make something work out with a sugar daddy too, what you doing? You from Brooklyn?
No. Never. Doing?
I'm just saying though,
Yo, Bella, man, you holding? What's good?
Yeah, you is kind of eating well.
No, that's this me.
Oh my,
this me, man. No blocking.
Nobody else can beat this moment. Beats, take this moment, please.
Yo, now we gonna talk behind the scenes, man. About here, my rap.
If you guys think y'all could get him down, then to talk about it.
Yeah, we might just have an episode with both of y'all here, man. We might turn this into something else.
Oh, you can do that too. Hit him up.
You know what I mean? And we may make something.
I mean, you got his number? I'm pretty sure you.
What is his number?
What's his number?
What is his number?
What is it?
I'm pretty sure
that number on there.
I'm pretty sure you got his number.
Yo, you give us his number. We'll call him.
I got his cell phone number. Oh. $80 cell phone bill.
This guy is not winning.
Yo, you probably. Nah, I think you exaggerating right now. Yo.
Nah, you know what?
This guy can't be doing that.
Yo, I'm gonna tell you like this, Gramps. I personally know.
I
personally know Bella, I've never taken her to one bullshit at all.
So what's his house number? Let's get his house number.
We ain't got no house. Like, do we even have a house? Do we?
No, don't affect his moms. That's not nice.
I mean, we will be polite when we call. We're gonna be like, hello, ma'am. It's so and so here at the house.
Indeed. Yo, well, Bella, we gotta wrap it up, unfortunately.
Let me get the house number.
Huh? What's that?
She about to get the house number.
She about to get the house number.
Yeah, you ain't here. She's scrolling on her phone right now.
Listen.
She about to get the house number.
Oh, man.
She's out for war. She is.
That's what's up.
It's a woman's
call. Woman's call.
Bella, we got to, listen, give us the house number on Facebook.
Damn,
we got to get to the show. We got Zoo Muzik group in the house, so we got to keep it moving.
Yeah,
but, yo.
Oh, she said, oh, no, you don't.
We're going to give him
a
call.
And you, chemo, yo.
What's up?
I don't know.
Yo, you know what's so funny? Bella, you do know this is a recorded show that goes over and over and over again on YouTube and Ustream and Facebook. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And it might go on
over and over and over again. I'm going to start it right now.
Miss Bella, yo, she knew this before she called. She knew what it was. She knew the game.
Yeah.
So you must.
I put it on Facebook.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
She was on Facebook. Not alive.
We knew what it was, man.
I'm sorry, baby.
Hey yo, fellas out there, this is a perfect example, man.
Yeah, don't
tell
it.
Your female.
Don't even do it to yourself.
I'm telling you, man. You better
don't do it to yourself, man. Well, listen, Bella, we gotta wrap it up, but we're gonna get back to this, and we're gonna definitely be in touch with you and catch on the backstory on this, and we're gonna get in touch with him and see his side of the story.
Yo, if he catch her, yo, he gonna beat her ass.
No, he's not.
Shut up, man.
No, he's not.
Listen. Bella, thanks for calling us up. I'm going to be in touch with you. I'm going to holler at you. You already know.
All right.
My video. Yeah.
Yo, that was the best put-on blast ever.
Wow.
Each call just gets better and better.
It does, right? I said it.
If he's a real nigga, he's going to beat that ass, though. Come on, man.
Nah.
Hold up. Too much information on the air, my man.
Just Rock Mic Radio Show. Come on now.
Hold up.
Like Graham said, there's two sides every story.
That's his side, that's the truth.
You know what I'm saying? So my thing is this, there had to be something wrong with her for him to really step out.
Yeah.
Ooh,
she probably wasn't.
If you listen to the whole story, she said it all wrong. She wanted the sugar daddy nigga, but that nigga probably figured it out.
She called him the husband, though. So that means she was supposed to be locked in one and only.
You can't squeeze blood from a stone. Like, what are you talking about, man?
Yeah. I'm sorry?
You can't squeeze blood out of a stone. There was no way he's going to be a sugar daddy. If you can't pay $80, come on, dogs.
I wish you still had
it. Maybe he lost it along the way. Maybe the recession hit him
in particular. I wanted to ask if he hit, though.
We're going to figure out what he got to say. We're going to get back to it. It's probably going to have to go to the next show, but we got Zoo Muzik group in the building. We're going to take a short break. I'm going to play that Go Crazy by VMS. You already know. And Latasha clearly has her hat. Already done. Elle is done with her hat. We're going to see. Yo, Gramps, where's yours, man?
You see, my shit ain't done.
Elle,
and I don't plan on doing it either.
You see the girls, they always make sure. They hold it down, man.
Maybe I'll get Latasha to do it for me. Here you go, Latasha.
Oh, man. Well, listen, we're going to get back to you. We got Go Crazy by BMS on that. Turn my mic on. And we're going to, right after that, we're going to go into that Zoom Muzik group. So stay tuned. Yeah.
Go crazy, show me how you work it. Go crazy, wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy, show me how you work it. Go crazy, wanna see you twerk it. Go to the riches, I drop it with bitches. Gold, no stitches, phone full of snitches. Flow so ridiculous, no home. I'm dickless. Coke for the snifters, low in them trenches. Dower for the duchess, drove for the swishes. I'm Rosemont popping, you so cold sipping. Swag past pimping, we so, so different. Bag chicks, shake that crazy ass. With a Nicki butt, but her face Stacey Dash. Work girl, make the cash. Give them thumbs up like I held a cab. Smart car, call me Candyman, gave for the Mars bar. Go crazy, bitch, shake it, porn star. Make it clap, clap, bring it back like an encore.
Make it bounce, girl, make it bounce, girl. Dip it low, girl, dip it low, girl. Bring it back, girl. I wanna see that booty go crazy. Wanna see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. I can make it wetter than the rain dance. Pipe game retarded like I'm Rain Man. Money in the air, watch it rain, man. Say it was the liquor when there's nobody to blame, man. Wanna know what we about? You're not rocking with the best, and I ain't even need a drop. Make the classy girl strip, homie, and I don't need a pop. Many niggas cuff it, ho, so we no longer needin' cops. Don't need ID and VIP, we chillin' in the back. Shorty's flocking in the team because they see we tossin' racks. No hands, no hands. She make that booty clap. You would think that she don't need it, the way she throw it back. Always get it in, ain't no shoulda had it. Black and Asian, she have it half like a sugar packet. Though her booty lookin' sweet, I ain't no sugar daddy. Make it twerk and work it, it's perfect, ain't got her looking at me. Make it feel good. Make it low, girl. Keep it low, girl. Bring it back, girl. Bring it back, girl. Make it clap, girl. Make it clap, girl. I wanna see that booty go crazy. Wanna see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. Show me how you work it, go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it, go crazy. Show me how you work it, go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it.
I'm on the road to the riches, I drove here with bitches. Gold on my wrists, cuts no stitches. Chrome for the snitches, flow so ridiculous. No homo, don't give a fuck like I'm dickless. Coke for the sniffers, low in them trenches. Dower for the duchess, drove for the swishes. I'm Rosemont popping, you so cold sipping. Swag past pimping, we so, so different. Bag chicks, shake that crazy ass. With a Nicki butt, but her face Stacey Dash. Twerk girl, make the cash. Give them thumbs up like I held a cab. Brains in the whip, call a smart car. Call me Candyman, gave for the Mars bar. Go crazy with that cake, shake your porn star. Make it clap, clap, bring it back like an encore.
Make it bounce, girl, make it bounce, girl. Dip it low, girl, dip it low, girl. Bring it back, girl, bring it back, girl. Make it clap, girl, make it clap, girl. I wanna see that booty go crazy. Wanna see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Go crazy, show me how you work it. Go crazy, wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy, show me how you work it. Go crazy, wanna see you twerk it.
I can make it wetter than the rain dance. Pipe game retarded like I'm Rain Man. Money in the air, watch it rain, man. Say it was the liquor when there's nobody to blame, man.
wanna know what we about. You're not rocking with the best and I ain't even need a drop. Make the classy girl strip, homie, and I don't need a pop. Many niggas cuffing hoes, so we no longer needing cops. Don't need ID and VIP, we chillin' in the back. Shorty flocking in the team because they see we tossing racks. No hands, no hands, she make that booty clap. You would think that she don't need it, the way she throw it back. Always get it in, ain't no shoulda had it. Black and Asian, she have it half like a sugar packet. Though her booty looking sweet, I ain't no sugar daddy. Make it twerk and work it, it's perfect, ain't got her looking at me.
Make it bounce, girl. Make it bounce, girl. Dip it low, girl. Dip it low, girl. Bring it back, girl. Bring it back, girl. Make it clap, girl. Make it clap, girl. I wanna see that booty go crazy. Wanna see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Let me see that booty go crazy. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it. Go crazy. Show me how you work it. Go crazy. Wanna see you twerk it.
From y'all niggas, that's that shit I don't like. Yo shit, make believe, rapping about my own life. Woo! That's Rand, nigga. Woo! Ric Flair, nigga. Woo! The power's in my head, nigga. Style!
Now she went though. You already know though. Only live once. That's a model. That's a
yellow. Pull something up when I take it out the stash. When I buy a house, I'ma pay straight cash. So I'ma flip a stack that don't make it come back.
Take the girls to Napa. Beat them to my mattress. My skeleton in my closet. It's probably dead and
what's up, everybody? It's Latasha. You guys are still tuning in to Juzz Roc The Mic. And right now, we're excited because we got the Zoo Muzik group right now.
Yeah.
Introduce yourselves, fellas.
All right, cuz.
Yeah, my name is Presidential Nitty, man. You already know. Uptown BX, we in the building.
All right.
You already know. It's your boy, Sonny Money.
How Sonny Money and Nitty.
You already know.
That's right, Sonny Money and Nitty. But y'all not even the only members. Y'all the only ones sitting with me right now, but y'all put some other ones, so y'all got to give them some shout-outs, too. But
yeah, shout-out my son, UFO Riz. You already know him in the building.
Bop, bop.
Cat Bell, we in the building. My son Payne not here right now. He had to take care of some other business. But
Max
shout out to
the...
The whole zoo, man. The whole BX, man.
We deep, though. We roll deep.
That's like a clan. How many members y'all got? That rap.
Oh, there's only like 3-4 of us.
Wait, y'all got departments or something? Y'all got rappers, yeah, administrators, yeah, secretaries, treasurers,
yeah,
like...
We a real official business.
There's only 2
yeah
departments. The rappers and the other guys.
And the other guy.
.. etc. Yeah. All right.
Yep, BX all day.
Now, how did you guys even like start up the whole Zoo Muzik group? First of all, let's talk about the name Zoo. Y'all that wild? Should I be like?
Nah,
should
like,
I be scared?
It really started like from like us rapping, like battle rapping. So people used to be like, "Yo, y'all animals and all that." Then when we got a little older, you know, we got caught up in the street. It became Zoo for animals for a different reason.
I forgot my bulletproof vest today, so no, y'all gotta. Can we keep the peace? Can we please keep the peace?
You don't need it.
Oh, okay. All right.
We came to drop off finest girls, so we had to chill for today. All of that.
Yeah. I know y'all bringing the romance today. Thank God, I am not built for this. Okay. Thank God. All right. So tell me what else. How did you guys find each other? How did you guys start up the whole Zoo Muzik group?
Well, most of us went to high school together, and you know, we started from the lunch tables and all that, like I said, battling and all that. Then, you know, Sonny always made beats, so he used to put the beats together. We always used to come rap. And then we started taking it serious. And, you know, I'm the CEO of Zoo Muzik Group and all that. So, like, you know what I'm saying? We put the business
boss
together. We all
presidential
bosses.
Yeah, everybody
we all
boss
bosses. We all bosses. You know what I'm saying? I'm just the CEO, you know? But, yeah, like, we just started taking it serious. And then we both went into situations where we both got incarcerated. So at the time, you know, it was super slow for us. And then we got back, you know, we started getting on our business aspect of it. And now we here, you know, finest girl.
Was y'all making those t-shirts like free my man so-and-so and like walking around the Bronx?
Nah, we wasn't trying to broadcast it that none of us was locked up. We was trying to keep it as low as we could because we didn't want that to jeopardize our image. So we didn't really put it out there.
I like that.
Yeah,
nah, we don't need no street cred.
We're going to have street cred regardless anyway.
Gangsters ain't doing too good, man. They in jail or dead.
Exactly.
So how do y'all go about selecting y'all members? How does one get indicted to the Zoo Muzik group? Since there's so many of y'all, y'all just giving everybody a chance, so y'all got to have like a standard. What's up, CEO?
Nah, it's not. It's like your work ethic. If you business-minded, like, if you're not business-minded, we're not taking you, simple and plain, because in the end of the day, we don't need no knuckleheads around us that's going to get us indicted, you know what I'm saying? So, in the end of the day, like, if you're business-minded, you take your craft serious, you know, here's a place for you. We all on the come up, man. Ain't nobody on, ain't nobody rich, and, you know, we just getting our money, and we just doing what we do.
All right, so talk to me about you guys' music. Like, hip-hop is such a broad, you know, genre. There's so many artists. What makes Zoo Muzik Group, like, stand out? Like, what are y'all doing for hip-hop right now?
I mean, as far as where we at in the Bronx, I feel like we make the best music, point blank, period. Like, we make our own beats. I make the tracks for the rappers. They hop on it, and it's all about our consistency. Like, some rappers could do a good song this day, and then it might be okay the next day, but we put out consistent good music, at least to us, you know what I'm saying, and let the crowd be the judge. But you know, the Zoo, we sound totally different because we're not scared to say what we want. That's the main thing about us. We don't, it's no holds bars without music, straight like that.
All right, now so y'all got your singles Finest Girls, all right? So yeah, y'all gotta describe to me who is the finest girl, and don't try to like flatter me or anything.
I was about to say you.
I want like the real.
I was about to say you too.
Come on.
It was definitely gonna be between you and Shorty right there. You know what I'm saying? Ooh. Yeah, even one of y'all would have got it. Dead ass.
Y'all should see this, some hot lady standing off camera now with the little leggings and
she's
the
not lying,
on.
Like that's facts. Trust me, facts. Facts.
So besides the ladies in the room, who was one of the finest girls y'all ever laid y'all eyes on?
I would say my baby mama, but it ain't like that no more.
We can't get no love for the holidays.
We good.
Sorry, baby moms. She slipped out of that position. What about you, Sonny?
Finest girl I ever seen. I never seen the finest girl I ever seen in front of my eyes. It was always like on TV or something. But it was Vanity. You know, remember from Prince?
From Last Dragon.
Yeah, from Last Dragon. Vanity. Vanity was always hot to me. And making good.
That sounds like a throwback. I don't know if I quite remember, but I'm going to Google though. It.
You're supposed to know who Vanity is. That's not good.
Why?
Y'all see that right there? She don't know who Vanity is, y'all.
Why?
I'm saying we're going to have to school it. Make sure you hit that Google up after you leave from here. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know.
Vanity
her
is
face.
Bad. What about Apollonia?
Who?
Oh, man. See? Yo, next question. We're just going to leave that alone. You know what I'm saying? We're going to leave that where it's at.
Apollonia?
Purple Rain. Purple Prince Harry.
Here's my problem, though. Like, I don't watch movies in its entirety. Like, I'm familiar with the classics, but they're always, like, in clumps. Like, you watch a scene, you walk away, or something happens. Like, that's why I never, and I'm always like, I never remember the movies. But anyway, back to you guys. So if you guys were tuning in, we were talking about cheap dates today.
Oh, boy.
Did y'all ever, either one of you, try it? Y'all tried a cheap date? Y'all took somebody out?
If I ain't got it, we ain't going nowhere. It don't make no sense to me. Like, I don't do
Come
cheap
on
dates.
Now, but you had it all the time
if
growing
I'm take,
up.
If I am taking a girl out, I'm going to make sure that I have it. Because I do not want to look like I'm popped and I don't have nothing. Image is everything. Pride is everything. So if I ain't got it, we ain't going nowhere. You can just text me. We can talk all night long. You know, have you laughing. If I ain't got it, we ain't going nowhere.
Nowhere.
He'll get you laughing over the text, lady. Don't slip on that. What about you, Sonny?
I'm a tourist, so it's all about me being comfortable. Like, I need to know I'm gonna be comfortable. So if I don't have no money, I'm not gonna go out. That's a wrap. So a chick like talking about a cheap date with Sonny, she lying. You know what I'm saying? I ain't never take no girl on no cheap date. But tell you the truth, I got a lot of girls that like to take me out on dates. I don't know why.
Oh, get in.
Yeah,
really?
A lot of girls
shout
like
out to
take
them.
Me out. I don't know.
We have another.
Shout out to them. Definitely shout out to
them. We have another kept man in the building.
Yeah.
So. All right. So we have like a music project or a mixtape that we got out right now. Or are you guys doing something that's upcoming?
I got my mixtape out. It came out on Election Day. It's called Criminal Minded 2012. If you're familiar with KRS-One, he's from the Bronx. He came out with an album called Criminal Minded. You know, I just redid it on some 2012 versions. Not the same songs, but, you know, the same vibe, the same feel for it. I dropped it. It's on Nat's Piff. Just type in Presidential Nitty Criminal Minded 2012. You know, as a group, they got the Zoo or Die Volume 1 out right now.
You heard. That's the hottest thing on
the
streets right
that's
now.
That's where Finest Girl came from.
Yeah. Finest Girl is the first single off the Zoo or Die Volume 1 mixtape. So make sure y'all go look for that. It's on that Piff. And, you know,
yeah, we got
the
more
next
time,
single, we're going to drop Twerk B. I'm not going to say the whole word.
Twerk Chick.
Yeah, Twerk Chick. We
twerk Lady.
Chick. You know what I'm saying? Twerk Lady.
Nah, you got
cool.
That. You got the her on it. Twerk
That's
chick.
The next single, though. That's for the girls. So whoever know how to twerk, just get busy.
That's All it. Right, so what's the most personal or the hardest song on that mixtape that y'all really want people to press play on? I know we want to listen to the entire project. What's that song that y'all like? That's it right there.
Well, I'm going
to
let him speak for the Zoo or Die Volume 1. As for Criminal Minded 2012, I got a song on there which I named Mama Said, which is basically me giving up my personal life to everybody who's listening. Let them know what I went through in life, you know, baby mama drama, trouble with the law. Watching my friends die, watching people go to jail, doing fed time, me in jail, you know, just speaking out, just saying that mama said it'd be days like this, you know, and just held my head high and just got through it.
you know what, I'm kind of scared of you, but you have such a nice vibe to you.
I'm not scared. I'm harmless.
Like, that was, like, that's not like a teardrop tattoo.
Oh, no,
nah,
it's
he
a
got
birthmark.
A cute little
it's shaped
birthmark,
as a heart.
Right?
I'm a 2013 hippie. We all about peace, man. No drama.
I know, that's right. What about your mixtape?
The Zoo mixtape, my favorite song. You said my favorite song or the hardest song?
Your favorite song, hardest song, most personal song. What's the track that you really want people to, like, really pay attention to?
I really want people to pay attention to Flossin'. It's a song on a mixtape called Flossin'. To me, that's my favorite song off the whole mixtape, just because me and my cousin is on there just swagging and going crazy with the swag. It's like we throwing swag at each other, like we having a swag match. So that's my favorite song, and I can't wait till we shoot that video.
All right, so keep people updated. I have any shows, anything that people could, like, see you guys, like, actually in person and check you guys out somewhere?
Well, for all the ladies' shows and all that, you could go to Facebook, Zoo Gang Music Group. You could go to my page, which is Fat Cat Young Dudders Nitty. You could go follow me on Instagram, which is Presidential Nitty Coke, on Twitter, Prez_Nitty.
All right, and any major projects for 2013? Any New Year's resolutions?
New Year's resolution, make more money than we did this year.
I definitely wanna smoke better weed in 2013 than I did in 2012. You know what I'm saying? You serious?
Did you see Kemostry's Christmas tree earlier? Oh, I don't know if you got. Did you see Kemostry's Christmas tree?
No.
It had no lights. No ornaments, no decorations, but it's a pile of kush. Maybe, you know, maybe you guys can decorate it.
We should
light
celebrate
it up
together.
Later.
Yeah. No, we smoke sour only, man. That's
loud
it.
Pack.
You heard?
Gramps is saying they got to get in that bubble kush.
That's Brooklyn shit? That's some Brooklyn shit?
That must be.
We don't come out to Brooklyn that much. You know, that guy's out here.
That's not really Brooklyn, though. That's Dykeman.
They have.
We go by
Tato. Anyway, represent for the heights. Yo, y'all, don't y'all got a video for that finest girl video, right?
Yeah, definitely.
I think I seen that before. I could have sworn I seen that, because I think I know a female that y'all did a video with.
What's her name?
I don't want y'all name.
I bet you it's the one that was in my scene.
There's a lot of ladies getting hot last tonight.
I just want to shout out Evander.
I'm just shouting out Evander.
My video girl?
Huh? I think he's talking about my video girl. Coco. He's talking about Coco. Shout out to Coco Chanel. She doing her thing. She doing the same thing we doing here right now, too. That's what she do. She's a radio show host.
She a good girl, man. Shout out.
But not for nothing, though. I ain't mean to cut y'all interview. Y'all doing y'all thing, though. Like, I be watching y'all shit. Y'all shit is all right, though.
Good looking,
like,
bro.
Real talk. Keep doing it.
Work hard.
It's hard. Like, it's really hard for, like, people, like, to really feed off of underground rappers like that. Especially, you know, if you ain't Lil Wayne or Drake, ain't nobody really trying to listen to you like that. If you ain't feeding off like that. But y'all doing y'all thing, though, so keep doing it.
Good looking, bro. Good looking.
That is actually something I'm interested in knowing. How can you sum up you guys' journey, starting from the bottom with the Zoo Music Group to where you guys are now, your whole journey as underground music artists?
Grinding, man. Working hard, just not giving up on it. There's plenty of times we just wanted to quit, like, yo, this shit ain't gonna work. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta have skinny jeans and all this type of extra shit that these cats is doing, right? But, like, nah, we just keep grinding, like, we from New York, and the end of the day, got to come back home. So that's how we feel. And especially in the Bronx, we just going to keep grinding till we make it.
What about you? How you feel about that?
Well, I mean, I don't consider us underground artists.
Okay.
Honestly, I feel like we just at the stage that we at right now until we get to the next stage. But my cousin, that's one of the most influential people out of our whole situation, because I watched him go from being able to not finish a whole song to being able to put together a whole mixtape by itself. So just seeing the growth from 2001 to 2013, that's what keep us going. That's the motivation.
Right. And what made you guys, like, just keep going and not quit? Or what advice do you guys have for artists looking at you trying to get at least where you at right now?
Just be yourself, man. That's it. Just be yourself and believe when people tell you it takes a lot of money to try to make it out here. Don't think that you just gonna get in just by talent. Like, nowadays with how hip hop is, it ain't about talent. It ain't about how nice you are and all that. We living in a swag era. We living in a wasted era. Nobody really wanna listen about the moon and the stars anymore. Everybody wanna go to the club, get drunk, and get wasted and sing your shit. So at the end of the day, Just be yourself, man, at the end of the day.
That's another thing, like, everybody don't have to be a rapper. It's a lot of positions in the business that we need people to do, and we need other people to hold. So everybody don't need to try to pick up the mic. We need some people promoting. We need some people shooting videos. We need engineers. So it's not just all about rapping, because you might not make it. Point blank, period.
Do you guys carry your Zoo Muzik job applications on you? So people
you
gotta
talk
like,
to Nitty about all of that.
Nah, what you want to work
my
for?
Department.
I'm just saying, if y'all hiring, cause
you hired.
I just quit my job last night. So if y'all could put me on some kind of payroll, I'll be forever grateful.
What can you do? You know how to sing, rap?
I'm not even gonna do it, cause y'all didn't pay for it. But what we gonna do right now is, do we want to get into some more singles by Zoo Muzik Group? Can we cue some up?
We can do whatever. We can spit live. We can do whatever. I'm with anything. We want to hear some? Want to hear some?
Now we're actually going to save you guys freestyle for the Juzz Roc The Mic session. Y'all all get on the mics and freestyle and go in, you know. Nothing written. That's as thug as I can get.
My cousin told me earlier ain't nothing free about our style, so therefore, at the end of the day, we just going to go in. Trust me.
All right. Y'all heard it here. Thank you guys for talking to us at Juzz Roc The Mic. You know, we going to...
Zoo, BX, Uptown. We in the
y'all check out Zoo Muzik Group. They going freestyle. We're going to play some more music, and we're going to get into it.
Like, why your pussy so tight? My ride or die, yeah, she by my side. And she rep the set like Zoo. And it's crazy sex when she hot and wet. And them sound effects is like, ooh. Ain't scared, yeah, that's my boo. Might make me say I do, yeah. That's my type when I lay that pipe. She coming twice, call it deja vu. Swipe.
All around the world, I've seen a lot of girls. But none of them was like you. None of them was like you. Always on my mind. One day you'll be mine. Cause I really like you. One day I might like you.
Finest girl that I seen, baddest girl that I want. She keep it real with me, holding still for me every time I got caught. Told her homie she a junk. He replied she too thick. I like my fluffy with a little bit of buffy and stuffy. I open up with this dick, then grind, wine, digging in it. Love it when I put my rhythm with it. Baby, you can come on, I don't want a small talk, I just wanna get in your rivets with it. So tell me what you wanna do, baby, how you wanna move? Cause you look like the wifey type. Let's see just what that life is like. She do with things she done. I mean, she's having fun. I remember last time, my favorite pastime turned the app, now she runs. Baby girl, I'm not done. Getting buzzed to the sun. When I'm tired, get guns.
Wine, digging in it. Love it when I put my rhythm with it. Baby, you can can come on. I don't want to small talk, I just want to get in your business with it. So tell me what you want to do, baby, how you want to move? Cause you look like the wifey type, let's see just what that life is like. She doing things she never done, all that means is she's having fun. I remember last time, my favorite pastime turned to apple. Buns. Baby girl, I'm not done. Getting buns to the sun. When I'm tired, get
when you see me in the street. Good music in this bitch, now drop that motherfucking beat.
Okay, now this for all of my enemies. I see me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. This to all of my hating hoes. I see me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. Hell yeah, it won't stop right now. This to all of my old hoes. I see me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. Hell yeah, it won't stop right now. See me getting guap right now. Hell no, it won't stop right now. Hell no, it won't stop right now. See me getting guap right now.
I need 50K large.
Right now.
My mama need a new crib.
Right.
right now. My daddy need a new car, right now. So I be going so hard, right now. Detroit is my yard, right now. I need a 17 car garage, right now. I need a 17 promenade, right now. I need a jailhouse to free my dogs, right now. I done pay taxes, pay dues, pay bills my whole life. So I'ma throw money in the air like I'm trying to pay the sky. Told myself that, man, if I can't live like this, I'd rather die. I give it up to God and he always reply. Control your hoes. You let her talk to you crazy. You got baby mama drama. You ain't even got you no baby. Fugazi. Boss up. Boss up with your time, dawg. You ain't got time for no hoes. I ain't even got time for no time off. I'm on.
All of my enemies that see me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. This the all of my hate.
Okay, I need 50k large, right now. My homie just beat the charge, right now. My brother need a new job, right now. So I be going so hard, right now. I need my face on a black car, right now. My iPhone need a charge, right now. My fist tank need sharp, right now. I need a blimp and say the world's hard, right now. So these niggas can know,
no.
I do what
they can't.
I'm stunning for all the people who ain't.
Dang.
You still hate,
woo.
You should be fucking ashamed. Far as I came, guess when you run in the game, they want you to sprain. Yeah, I know, but I don't get my stress on. Taking shots, swear it's like my stomach's made of Teflon. They like, boy, why don't you get your rest on? Bitch, cause I'm up for every hour I was slept on. The last night I dreamed about two girls bisexual. They was trying things, trisexual.
Yeah,
and I woke up in a city where the population master death toll. Drew my blueprint, got it illustrated, FF affiliated. Millions chasing, go to sleep. Wake up, continuated. Life of a Don, shine, Don, sipping. Never had a palm reading, always had my palms itching. Time to get it. Boy, I was taught to get it till it's gone. Even when I got it, watch me get it like I don't. Hold up. Tell me what you see. Pull up.
Swerve.
Watch these motherfuckers freak.
Watch them
say what up, though, when you see me in the street.
Good music in this bitch, now drop that motherfucking beat.
Okay, now this to all of my enemies. See me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. This to all of my hating hoes that see me getting guap right now. See me getting guap right now. Hell yeah, won't stop right now. This to all of my old hoes that see me getting guap right now.
Fraud niggas, y'all niggas, that's that shit I don't like. Yo shit, make believe, rapping about my own life. Woo! That's Rand nigga, woo! Ric Flair nigga, woo! The power's in my head nigga.
Style! Finish these dubs, down to the Kemostry Club. Finish these dubs, head out to the Kemostry Club. Finish these dubs, head out to the Kemostry Club. Finish these dubs, head out to the Kemostry Club.
No click, we don't fuck like an elephant. Get with a kick,
25 minutes. Now she went pro. You already know though. Only live once, that's a motto, that's a
yellow. Hold something up when I take it out the stash. When I buy a house, I'ma pay straight cash. So I'ma flip a stack the dough, make it come.
Yo, we back. Just Rock The Mic Radio, we here. Here with Zoo Muzik. Yeah, yo, y'all know what time it is, man. Oh, yeah. Well, actually, we got Gramps. It's been a minute since we did this Rock The Mic session without you, Gramps. Remember what you hear, man. So, it's going to be crazy. It's epic, man. This is that time, Rock The Mic session. But we got something else after the Rock The Mic session. So, don't go away just yet. There's something different, man. We don't usually do this, man, but we're going to do it. Whenever you ready, beats, we're going to give you a little history lesson, man. So, these beats right here, it's classic, man. You already know, man. Ready? Let's go.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
You know what time it is. We're gonna start here, we're gonna keep it this way.
Oh, you gonna start it like that?
Yeah.
You can bring it from my way.
Money.
Where we going?
Are you going to Michael Jackson joint?
Let me go to the next one, man. I don't like the Michael Jackson joint.
I started off.
I ain't dropping that beat.
Look, I'm straight stunting on these haters, yeah, that barely mean. Dominican chick who killing to my every need.
Yeah.
Blasting thug motivation, puffing heavy weed. Coop topless, like it's trying to get his Jerry beads. Crazy with the dope grams of the yay. Chick sprung, cause hard dick is what I happen to lay. I don't care if you bang dog the can in the spray. Take your flag, toss it like we trying to challenge the play. Hey, mismatched niggas better get their life in order. One blackberry text to get your posse slaughtered. I'm in the hood, make movies, play your part, nigga. Cocoa butter slugs to get rid of all these marked niggas. If a nigga say my name, he better ask permission. Hot head, icy jewels, I'm a contradiction. Came straight from them slums without a pot to piss in. What the money causing women in the yacht to shit in. I'm a motherfucking beast, no shackles on me. Running through blocks, haters trying to tackle on me. Shots to spin your body, how you talking backwards, homie? What's the slugs engaged? That's a perfect matrimony. Two gang slime, quick with the gun. Run up in your spot when you with your bitch and your son. Taking your jewels and had the two sit by your lungs. Hands up, yo, looking like 5 minutes to run.
Came in as a teenager blazing trees. Now my name's spreading faster than the AIDS disease. And I still get harassed by them agencies. They call a low type tonight. Even paging me and my zodiac. Be the jungle sun, king of the tree. I'm like a killer whale, killing every shark that I see. Long shark, blue shark, kid, don't matter to me. I'm killing sharks with harpoon guns more than Jordan P. This is me, who you go to a beat? Some other rock MC, I'm on my 34th floor. And y'all stuck with 23, fake buzz, get on MTV. Like a nigga from the street to make a couple of G's. Keep it real with you and keep it real with me, alright. I'll get your head chopped and tossed in the high tide. I'm riding by loyalty, faith in my royalty. Mind on my money, yet my monster royal me. Rolling hot, and I don't care if you stay or not. Without your negativity, it's no me. Getting better as the days come. Blazing with Jason, riding till we age on a weekly occasions. Here's my illustration of a star in distress. Leave you at the bar, leave you washed out on the steps. When I float and I'm stumbling, mumbling wet, I'm sweating like two heavyweights going left.
Money, check it. Listen, yo, I'm about to show these niggas about my shell game. Y'all niggas just start fucking with the heat, like L. James. I'm retired, I don't sell cane. You probably fill your whole body with cologne and still smell lame. I tell dames, call me Bud Bundy. If you smoking on that backyard boogie, stay the fuck from me. I get high, plus fresh, plus money. Matter of fact, from now on, call me Plus Sunny. Call me Plus Sunny. You heard?
Yeah, look.
Beats is tripping.
Let's go.
We gonna let it rock, bro.
I was labeled as a crack baby, born in the crack 80s, when niggas was rocking Kangos and pushing crack crazy. Always been the problem child, a BX boy with a BK mind, but a Harlem style. Pops didn't leave me nothing but alone. Ain't no father figure, had to get tough on my own, so I moved on. Spent too long in the hood, but I grew strong. Ain't nothing like in why, for real. And people wonder why my nerves is bad, cause life's a bitch, you wouldn't learn this shit until she burn your ass. So I acknowledge my breath and polish my steps, cause ain't nothing promised but death. Ain't no breaking that, ain't no escaping that. Reality's reality. The niggas going to war sad to see it straight ascended. My weapons of mass destruction is all religion. Jews versus the Muslims, Muslim versus the Christians. Religion collision, they feed in your brain. War for war, we pray to the same God, it's just a different name. The same shit, black man, is just a different day. The same struggle, white man, is just a different pain. Same book, little mama, just a different page. Same anger, little nigga, just a different rage. And the cops get paid to shoot blacks, but they give us 25 years when we shoot back. True fact.
Yeah, listen. Check it. Yeah, listen. Still. Now I can do this with my eyes closed. I'm 4 or 5 clips in the van to leave your eyes closed. You'll be chasing Tweety Birds like Sylvester. The lawn in the rain, nigga, I chin check ya. Was born with a dream, now I try and get the screen. Just born, be the team, we take a flick, now I mean. It's rise of machines, but watch how you lean. We're a Terminator squad, no one even made a thing, huh? Yeah, I know you'll be coming back. This ain't football, you can't even get a quarterback. And this is how I roll, though. This is how I do every day, and I'm solo. Roll up the dome, and I'll be on the hit. Can't stop me now, cause I'm tear like Rocky. Can't in my top three, I'm the
Hush, dummy, I could teach you a thing or two. I get pussy, why? Cause cause that's the thing to do. 650s, M6s, Dreamer Crew. Anything less than that 5 series, don't bring them through. And I'm a slimmer too, so I keep a Dutch lit. I don't fuck with hoes, I don't suck dick. I'm the MC with the hammer, nigga, you can't touch this. I'm so hot, dog, where the fuck is the mustard? When I'm on that Henny, I get wet like my nuts get. When I'm on a teabagging, I'm in the mood swagging. It's about to get ugly like that bitch G-Wagon. What I spit is equivalent to 3 dragons. See my feet passing? You just sit and watch. I just bubble like bologna in that kitchen pot. And if you ain't in it getting guap, you might as well catch your body and go sit up in that prison box. Listen, I not for nothing, I'm a sick bastard. You're a race, your mom should've had a miscarriage. I don't need a mix cause I got my shit mastered. What's your little starter kit? What's that, 6 carrots? Like a hot song, I could get your click blasted. Feeling foggy to leap, you gotta itch scratch it. They still stuck on my past, they can't get past it. My shit magic, fuck balls, I spit acid. Ask the OGs how I often grind. I'm a pimp like Goldie, keep my horns in line. Think I'm off point cause I'm high, you lost your mind. I'm sharper than a porcupine when it's coughing time. Look how I floss and shine. You probably wanna rob me, don't let it cross your mind. I got robbed once and I ain't get my chain back. Same nigga got shot and he ain't get his brain back. Fresh pair of Phoenix, took the morning sauce. Black diamond, looking like soy sauce. Got your girl screaming, about to make shorty horse. Got enough guns to break Peter and Corey off. Holla, nigga.
Fuck, why y'all stop these niggas? Not a fake nigga's twisted.
Throw that back on, let my cousin. Yo, cuz gonna zip it up and we out of here.
Zip it up?
Yeah. Zip it up, cuz.
Alright, check it.
Get him.
I ain't gonna spit
the top. Get your tapes ready.
It's over for that positive shit.
That's it.
Look, yeah. Let's set the record straight. Niggas ain't as nice as me. I tear the roof off, I JFK snipe the V. Bitch, better than the baby kid. Shells love to adopt, aka raise your kids. The rhymes is out, Osama your house. Beat the insides out your bitch, I pin you out of your spouse. Tell you what the pouting about. They green stay garbage, niggas got that Oscar the Grouch. See the closet full of kicks, boy, I sock it out. Bitch, I'm guaranteed to shoot when the cock in your mouth. I'm in love with money, hoes, and tall choppers. Dreadful since birth like a nigga was born roster. I'm filled with shells, no pasta. Man, I take shots to the head, no vodka. The way the stone shine in the bezel was so proper. Fly boy, stay around Gucci, no rocker. Bitch, sniper, Ben Thriller. Yeah, your bitches meet the fuckers, Ben Stiller.
I got the shooters in the garrisons.
Swear some of these Bronx rap niggas embarrassing. Montana, Godson, and UP. There's a port of Corey Guns, and now you can include me. I say your name, report to the nearest roof. And jump the fuck off, get your body scraped and scoop. F Dr. Nose, bitch, I'm the latest scoop. These rappers on the hot water, get a cup of soup. If they got a king, I'm like, who the fuck is you? I ain't meet the baddest chicks in the world, but fuck the few. Password like Home Depot. Niggas wanna live a movie till there's no sequel. Niggas get their home repo. Younger wanna have child's play with grown people. Wanna know what you thinking, I give your drama people. The whole case is odd, we can never eat. I'm going ham. You niggas go to Muslim food, you bean pie niggas. I cover bodies like the Muslims do. Die for the cause, move like a Muslim move. Get money and makes a lot like a Muslim do. Miss Gate Key Club scream when it's due night. Rumors used to pop off, Sin City platoon tight. No, let the wolves out anytime, let the moon bright. Watch out, let the bitches take off, it's like a Zoo's night. Wake up and face a nightmare. Don't fight fear, cannon will knock you out your night gear. Criminal mind, yeah, it's getting worse. Ride fresh to death, you think I'm whipping in the hearse. Mixing in the kitchen while I'm fixed to getting thirst. I'm getting rap money, only hustle on the first.
Motherfucker, zip him up, all the way up. Body bag.
Body bag.
Body bag.
I don't want to rap more, I just want to listen.
We can keep going, man.
We can keep going, man.
Like,
I'm back in the 90s or some shit. Like, I'm listening to the Rough Riders or some shit right now.
BX. BK.
Yo, you seen it. This is BX, man. They went hard for BX, man. Yo, I had to give that to you, man. Yo, y'all held it down, man. Yo, BX go hard, man. You know what I mean? That's what it is, man. Zoo Muzik. That was Latasha.
That wasn't a dream, nigga.
Yo,
reality.
Yo, it's crazy, man. You ain't even. Yeah. Yo, Gramps was like, I'm not even gonna get involved. Yo, you already know, man. Zoo Muzik Group, they here, we here, they came back, held it down. Make sure you check them out, man. Find this girl, that's their single, man. It was.
Yo. Go check out that Criminal Minded 2012 on that piff, and that Zoo or Die Volume 1 on that piff. We out here.
You already know, man.
BX in the building.
Shout out to Rock.
Yo, y'all gotta do me one thing, yo.
What's up?
Y'all gotta say BX with me crazy, yo.
BX!
Y'all gotta say crazy.
BX
in
the building.
I gotta
say BX. You dig?
You did. Friends want y'all to go home with BX because nobody really go home.
Nah, tell him we keep it.
He's like, on the load of BX. Nobody go home for all of us. Yeah, all right, man. So we gonna be right back, man. I got somebody I want y'all to meet. And we gonna be right, man. Remember, Zoo Muzik Group, man. BX.
She went though. You already know though. Only live once. That's my model. That's
the yellow. Roll something up when I take it out the stash. When I buy a house, I'ma pay straight cash. So I'ma flip a stack that don't make it come. Yeah. Baby girl, get napper. Beat it to my mattress. A skeleton in my closet. It's probably dead and rapper.
She can have a Grammy. I still treat her like a nominee. Just need to know what that book like. So one time is fine with me. Thank you.
Yo, yo, just Roc The Mic Radio. We back, man. We got a caller. On hold. We got somebody we need to. Yeah. Let's see. Yo, just Roc The Mic Radio. We here.
Yo, what's up?
What's going on? Who's this?
Yo, this Haas.
Haas? Turn your volume down.
Oh, okay. My bad.
Yeah, this Haas. Where you from, Haas?
From Buffalo, New York.
Okay, all right.
West Side. We the drain to New York City, but we still here.
Okay, all right. That's what's up, man. So what's going on, man?
You know, I'm holding my head with both hands. You know what I'm saying? Because my neck can't do it no more. Just maintaining.
All right. I hear that. I hear you, man.
What's the topic? I see y'all got two nice-looking young ladies.
Well, actually, the topic of the day was just talking about cheap dates and, guys that maybe take ladies on cheap dates. And, you know, we want to know, what's your cheapest date, man? Have you ever taken a girl on a cheap date, man?
Oh, yeah, ain't nothing wrong with taking a nice lady on a date.
Well, what about a cheap date?
Excuse me?
Have you taken her on a cheap date?
Nah. You know, the black woman is the queen of the planet. So, we only can do as good as she do. You know what I'm saying?
I hear that, man.
But we all got mothers. We all came from we all got mothers. So,
right.
Respect the black woman like your mother, and you're going to come out on top.
All right,
amen.
Man. Well, that's what's up, man. Well, listen, man. We would love to chat longer, man, but we really pressed for time. We're wrapping up the end of the show, man. But thanks for calling us up, man. I hope you tune in next Saturday, man. From us between 6 and 8, man. We just had a little run over, man. But we had a lot of things going on. Zoo Muzik group in the building. But you can definitely check back and recap and see everything that we did on the show, man. Just Roc The Mic Radio, man. You heard?
True indeed. I just want to send a shout out to my man Shawn Smith. Keep doing your thing.
That's
supporting y'all. Now I'm seeing hope y'all, you know, the blessings from Jah pour on all of y'all.
Yo, that's what's up.
Yeah,
all right. All right. Y'all Godspeed. Y'all have a good night. All right.
You too, man. God bless, man. Salute.
That was Sean's big thank you.
Yeah. Yo, Shawn gets love on here, though. People be calling Shawn up, man. Be like, yo.
You the greatest, Shawn.
Yeah. Shawn's cool, man. We love Shawn, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, but listen. I know y'all wondering, like, what happened? You know, you see this new person in the corner. This is Mimi, and she's our guest co-host.
How you guys?
Mimi!
And potential host. You know, we're trying to see, you know, what can happen here, you know.
Testing it out.
We're seeing how this go, you know. And,
Not for nothing, this mic stinks right now. I don't know who had it, but it smells so bad. I got this microphone back. It smells so bad. So
wow.
Whoever was in charge of
light skin.
Light skin. Yeah.
I don't know.
Who was going in?
He was going in. He probably slobbered all over it. It's probably all his. He should have had a breath mint.
That was a dope freestyle. I'm just catching my breath now. Watching that.
Yeah, that freestyle was crazy. It was. I ain't gonna front. It was one of the dopest ones I think that we had here. But listen, Mimi.
I haven't seen anything like that in so many years. I really haven't. I mean, that was beautiful.
Okay.
I mean, everybody sounds the same now. I mean, we needed something different. I'm sorry. I had to say it.
Real quick, Mimi, because we're pressed for time. We don't got much time, but I got to just tell everybody why you think you should be here with us on Just Roc The Mic Radio.
Oh, I can give you versatility.
In 60 seconds, go.
I can give you versatility. I can give you what you want.
No, we're going to come back with a part two with that. Because I see she got a lot to say, you know what I'm saying? So, Kemo.
That was fun. No, I enjoyed the show. I definitely did. So, I mean, you guys are great.
Okay, that's what's up.
But like I said, I could give you versatility also. So, I mean, that's what you're looking for. All right. Why not? Because I know you're trying to make this a big thing, you know?